teams, both teams in the huddles now, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to kick off here at the Maher Stadium for the 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final. Brought to you by today the NHP. Give your local sales rep a call.
Station sponsor. Don't forget that. And interesting, they're huddled right in front of the Boca cheer squad, which is in the far right-hand pocket of the bigger grandstand here at Maher Stadium.
There's about 20 people down there.
Hey, they've got balloons. They've turned out. They've actually come out and forced to buy both nights.
Oh, I think that's great. That's fantastic.
I think you'd call them Beaufort nights, wouldn't you?
You would call them Beaufort. They've come down the highway, the 20-25 minute drive from Beaufort. So thanks for coming, guys. Appreciate you rocking up here today. Very, very shocked, though, at this crowd. So we'll just see what the numbers look like in Victoria this week.
Well, I think because they're all seated and there's a big congregation up on the hill, which is fantastic. There's more on the outer side hill again. No surprise, there's a group band down on the other side of the hill, which looks like a good vantage point to watch football from. And also, they've got the social club area, which is all blocked off, but there's a few people spattered around there. No one's really sitting beyond the goals down the Crescent end of the ground, or, yeah, we'll call it the North End, or whatever you want to call it.
Crescent Road.
Crescent Road end. It's not really going to be Crescent Road these days, is it?
Well, probably not. Starting on the bench for Beaufort, guys, Jaden Orr, Joey Mason, Zane Thompson and Damien Day. Stevie McConville's in the centre of Maher Stadium, ready to kick off the 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final.
Will he bounce it?
He won't bounce it, Dave. Across to you, mate, for the main call.
Yes. So lining up for Beaufort in the ruck.
Josh McDermott,
ready to jump up. I can't just get eyeballs on the Hepburn ruckman just yet. They're trying to sort each other out. A bit of pushing and shoving, a bit of just trying to feel each other out. Nothing too untowards. They're about up the way. The umpire rises the ball above his head. And we're out to go.
It's going to be the
ruck contest won clearly by Hepburn. They all pile in. A nice fired handball out in the path of Hepburn. Now clearing kick down towards their forward line. Big contested mark. Massive, massive jump by Aaron Bruns, who took out three
Jared Triggs down.
Yeah, he copped it into the back of his head. Grabbing the ball again. Is Bruns again after taking a grab. Fires it forward, but a mark taken in the defensive half by Mitch Jenkins. So Jenkins goes back and kicks it wide out to the other side wing to a two-on-one, really. And it's not really going anywhere. It's a scrapping apart over it. Clearing kick now. Oh, tackled without the ball was a Hepburn guy going without the agate, but he kept play. The umpire says play on. Clearing kick now by Tim Horsey. Handball's back again. Back to Tim Horsey. Horsey just hoists one straight up in the air to a contest. No one. Hepburn comes down with the ball, tries to get it out. The umpire calls play on. And the ball's just bouncing around back and forth on the other side wing, not really going anywhere. Another clearing kick again by Joshie McDermott. Tumbles into the forward line, but now scooping it up is Stanton, who fires a handball out to his teammate McHalloran, who was under the pump.
Hepburn's Aaron Burns, got a bit of a stinger in that last contest, Dave. He's just down there, 450, trying to walk it out. A bit of a stinger, mate.
And Triggy's gone from the ground. He copped a good knee to the back of the skull, and he's still feeling the effects of that.
Which brings on Damien Day for both of them.
Yes, correct. And now, with the ball, who's Lachlan Murray, who now fires it forward into the 450, top of the square. Mark bounced off the chest of Jack Duke. He probably should have done more with it, but everyone piles on top of it. Right, just short of the centre, the goal square. And Jackie Duke hit him on the chest and bounced straight out. Could have been a very good start, but the umpire will ball it up right on the point of the 10-yard square.
Beaufort really need to lock this ball in there, 450. Hepburn getting that first centre clearance. They really need to lock this in now.
Tap run out by Hepburn onto to the Beaufort player, unfortunately, who kicks out into the path of Jack Duke, who's chasing it, taps it back into his teammate's path, but he's coat hanging. The umpire doesn't see it. He's tackled. The umpire says, play on, letting them scrap it around. The Hepburn grabs the ball into the path of O'Halloran. O'Halloran just fires a haymaker handball out to a Beaufort player, then gets smoked, tackled. The umpire says, you're not going anywhere. I'll have the ball. So it's the ball's 45 metres out. Beaufort's end, scoring end.
The first 2 minutes of the game, Dave, Hepburn five tackles to Beaufort's four. Very, very tight, tussled game.
The skills aren't on, actually. They're just real rushed. But the ball now, again, is just in the pack, wrapped up in a tackle.
Good tackle.
Is, again, looked like it's Stanton down there, and he gets ridden to the ground. And he'll get up and now buy a ball up. So ball moved about 5 metres closer to the Beaufort goal.
Still no sign of Jared Trigg off the bench, mate. Still down there.
Probably trying to get Bruns' knee out the back of his head. So the ball up now. Hepburn clearing handball, but goes nowhere into the path of a Beaufort bloke who gets creamed in the process, and the ball's bouncing around just that 50-metre arc for the Hepburn for Beaufort, I should say. And the ball's locked up again, and the umpires say, I'll have it. And the ball's moved 15 metres forward.
Very, very stagnant game. 3 minutes, 12 into the first quarter.
Right on the arc of the Beaufort's 50 metre. And another ruck contest won comfortably by Hepburn. And the ball's again bouncing around. Good click out by Joshie McDermott, who finds it forward. A pack forms, hits the deck. No one there to rove it, and they're fighting over it again. Quick handball out in the path of Mitch Jenkins, who bananas it for a goal. And that's the first one for the day. Mitchie Jenkins' goal.
Three inside 50s for Beaufort for one score, and Hepburn getting the one inside 50 with no scores yet. First goal, 3 minutes 40 into the first term.
And it is just a scrap fest. And
it is, yeah. Well, hopefully it clears out a little bit once there's a bit more run in both teams' legs. So we'll see how that progresses throughout the afternoon here at Mars Stadium.
Most definitely. So same umpire's got the job again.
Stephen McConville.
Is he a race car driver?
That's
Josh, he wins the turnout again.
Oh,
and
the
bloke gets coat hangers, his head for an opponent. And he's still looking around looking for his head, but the umpire says, no, mate. And taking the kick will be O'Halloran. O'Halloran right in the middle of Mars Stadium. Handballs it back, a long driving kick into the Hepburn forward line. Do a two-on-one, a poor kick really in the circumstances. There should be easily mopped up by Beaufort. One handball. Looking again, another wide handball into the path of Jack Morrow. Zach Morrow sells a bit of candy. He turns it back and handballs it to his teammate, who just kicks it into the middle of the ground to no one in particular. To be honest, it was to Hepburn's advantage. Short kick by McKay, who now following up the own kick, just kicks it high into the forward line. Coming forward is Burns. Burns has taken a great grab, 25 metres out, slight angle, should go back and kick it. He might have a bit of heart, he's still got half a trick's head on his knee.
Dave, inside the first 5 minutes, mate, Beaufort six tackles to Hepburn seven. Very, very tight and tussled game in 5 minutes of football. Fairly highish tackles.
So Burns, the left footer, comes in with a real tight man bun too. Really tight. Leans back with the kick, straight out the umpire's hat.
Great goal.
And the umpire says, all clear, thank you very much. And Burns is on the scoreboard. So it's one goal each, 5 minutes gone. First quarter of the Central Highlands 2017 Grand Final.
Fantastic start, very tight, tussled game here. Both teams have been very, very skillful early on. As long as that rain again holds away, we'll be very nice, tight tussle throughout this game. So hopefully, six tackles to seven, as I said before, very, very even across that.
Oh, most definitely. And then coming on for the Hepburn team is the fish, Sean Salmon. He's just hanging out in the outer wing. He's just hoping to try to get a little cheeky sneak. And the ruck contest again, won by no one in particular. O'Halloran at the bottom of the pack, fires it back, but smothered now getting the ball is Stanton. Stanton fires a little handball back, a chip kick. Again, now taken, well, it looks like it's Anscombe. Anscombe kicks it long into the forward line to no one in particular and buttering it up.
Lee Marshall?
Is Lee Marshall, then drives it forward and smacking on the chest is McCorkle. McCorkle hands it out wide. And then a grubbing kick into the forward 50. Should have done more. It looks like Halsey. And it was a terrible kick by Halsey. He had a lot more time. Just kicked it along the ground. Now it's a boundary throw in. Right through centre wing in front of the other hill with the drink van on it. There's enough surprises. Another group of people out that far of the world.
Just congregating around each drink van, aren't they?
They really are. So a boundary throw in. A good boundary throw in too. And reaping it from the pack is Hepburn. A long driving kick to the forward line. Burns in front, should have taken it, goes to the ground too easily. Now buttering up is Beaufort, and now with the clearing kick, it looks like Lee Marshall. Lee Marshall now turns the ball over, the handball back to Andy McKay. Andy McKay sells two bits of candy, kicks it back to O'Halloran. O'Halloran sits, comes back.
Very, very cool head, O'Halloran. He should play it well here.
So looking for Cox. Cox is leading to the other side. O'Halloran goes in that department. Cox comes out of it, grabs it.
Great, man.
Fantastic grab by Cox.
Oh no, Tony!
Oh, and now there's a bit of a scap as well, a bit of a kick, a push and a shove. Cox is like, I'll go back and kick this, please, mate.
Umpire Robbie Simmons has got a line of control there. Fantastic, good call, good free kick too. End up paying the free kick for too high.
I tell you, so I said, oh, how did I call that earlier? I should be out there playing.
I tell you what, Dave.
Well, said, too old, too slow, too fat.
Very experienced head, O'Halloran was always going to set up that play. And again, inside 50 for Hepburn, they are. So 3-4.
So one of the premier goal kickers in the Central Highlands, Lee Cox, very deliberate approach. He's going to kick from just on 40 metres, leans back of the goal, big air that he celebrates it early, and
great
goal.
Kick.
And he tells the Beaufort supporters all about it as well. He pulls it on and let him know. was a fantastic kick from 40 metres, and the push and shove started again.
That makes Beaufort 1-6 to Hepburn 2, straight 12, 8 minutes gone, first turn, Mar Stadium.
So Foster's at in straight into Cox again. There's a bit of a push and a shove. The umpires are taking a look at it. Not much towards, just a bit of junk of pulling and throwing, but the umpire, no, he's going to pull a free kick. And there's still just a push and shove right on Hepburn's half forward line. Won't do much more than just a bit of a push and shove. They're too smart. In fact, there's three players out there. Three umpires, just to say. So another ruck contest won by Justin McDermott, but the clearance again by Hepburn. He kicks it forward, but a terrible bounce. Didn't favour anyone in particular. The Hepburn pretty much got his head ripped off, but the umpire didn't see it. And again, spot fires start again. This time it looks like it was Goodsall who started the push and shove again. So the umpire's trying to find the nomination, which is a joke in AFL football.
Josh McDermott up against Hepburn's Jackson Hogan.
No one, in fact, just palm down to the ruckman's feet, and they all pile on, stacks on the mill, and the ball is going nowhere. And Hogan and Josh McDermott, who's got a fair size advantage over his Hepburn counterpart, who should be doing more with it, to be honest.
Hepburn, 3 centre clearances to Beaufort 0.
Again, looks like Beaufort, there should be a hold the man decision there. The umpire's blindsided, the pack forms again, and the ball's moved about three or four centimetres from where we just called it before.
It's very hard. It's a hold in that 50 metre line, isn't it, in under the ground, down the Lake Minnere end.
Almost definitely. And the ball now just kicked out really quickly out of the pack in front of Burns and his opponent. Burns quick to his feet, but O'Halloran gets his head taken off.
High umpire.
The umpire finds it. Yep. Not officiating umpire. Finds O'Halloran. He has been the base of every single pack today. I'll
tell you what, it helps have an experienced head, Dave, I would have thought. Very, very helps.
I don't know about experience. He's got a hard hit.
He does. He's about 30 metres out, directly in front, down the Lake Minnere end, the old scoreboard end.
Old scoreboard end, showground end, Ballarat end. You don't want to call Ballarat end.
Not the Ballarat end, though.
I'm going with the Ballarat end. I'm going to the city end. And now O'Halloran gives it everything. He's got it. It goes back.
Great goal. Great goal, O'Halloran.
He gave that every ounce in the Hepburn Heights here. Majority of them standing in front of us, sitting in front of us, they are going off their heads.
Hepburn 3 straight 18 to Beaufort's 1-6. One goal. 10 minutes 20 gone, first turn, Mar Stadium.
Yes, and it's Hepburn have got, sorry, Beaufort have got the ruck dominance. They're getting the tap outs every single time.
Last 5 minutes, Dave, Hepburn have just dominated this game with getting quick kicks inside 50. Helps straight away, you get a couple of free kicks.
So Garvey now into ruck for Beaufort. Ruck contest again, won by Beaufort again, but they're not taking full advantage, just like Fremantle and Sandals, they seem to be reading the Beaufort taps. The ball again, it looks like another clearance out for Hepburn, but the sideways kick towards the interchange bench has been chased previously by Hepburn, doing a fantastic job to keep it in was Wills. Wills then folds it up, kicks it down the line again, and then the Beaufort team, I should say, in Foster, gets the ball, drives it down, but oh! Flying across in front of two Hepburn opponents.
Dish.
Was the Petrie dish. The Petrie kicks it long, but almost a grab by his teammate in Stapleton, who's gone down holding his knee, and he's not in a good way.
I reckon that was Lachlan Murray, Dave.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Right, it was Lachlan Murray. That'd be a big out if he's hurt his knee.
He's
as now the ball is just handballed freely by Hepburn away. He gets smoked over the line. Hepburn again got hammered. The push and the shove again.
It's on
now.
Obviously,
he's played
a free kick to Beaufort.
He's just played a free kick to Beaufort for too high. And coming in late was the fish and salmon. He's given away the free kick for too high. Real poor decision there. And the Hepburn crowd, as you can hear, they're not happy.
Michael Foster
right
in front of us.
Right, now a reversal. Reversal again now. And this is the crowd.
Yeah.
Shoot out.
He's really milking in front of the crowd here, Dave. Fantastic to see, mate. Burnsy up high.
So he kept down by Brown, but Burns, he missed it. Oh, he's played a free kick. The mark was taken. Just let the mark stand. The original mark was taken by Marshall. But Foster now will take the ball, looking for a switch. But they had to take him right back to the goal square. He goes with it. Burns to stay on the mark. He's got nowhere to go. They've sacrificed 40 metres in the aid of going nowhere, really. Just deeper in the four of their back line.
Both at 10 goals versus Hepburn 7. Sorry, 10 tackles versus Hepburn 7.
Thompson kicks it out just outside their defensive 50, gathered up in the tack, in flight is Horsey, who kicks it down the line. And again, Hepburn are there in massive numbers, and then a clearing kick out in the park of Brown. Brown takes the mark, handballs across into the path of Hogan. Hogan snaps, turns, and just misses. Just misses. It was a beautiful bit of play.
It was Hepburn getting a lot of footy. Davis first quarter, 13 minutes gone. Beaufort one straight six to Hepburn, 3-1-19.
Terrible kick out, didn't make the distance, but they've managed to clear it up. A looping handball at the or on the outer side wing, kicks another one down the line, spoiled from behind by Hepburn. And his teammate, which was Garvey, tries to chase it back, but Dave, over the bound.
Sorry, center clearances, Dave, 5-0 in this first term, 13 minutes gone. That's a lot of clearances to Hepburn.
Oh, most definitely. And they're not making, and Beaufort are winning every tap out. If we had hit out stats, it'd be
absolutely
in favour of Beaufort easily. But this one, beautiful tap down and clearance by Beaufort, but he just kicks it to nobody with his Hepburn apart. Hepburn is standing in the middle of the square. A nice long clearing kick out. And now they drive forward into the and taking the mark on his chest. It's Brown. Brown on the boundary line.
Right,
takes
it. Brown.
And he's led by the goal record as well. And they're starting on fire here.
4-1-25 Hepburn to Beaufort, one straight six, 14 minutes gone. 2013 Central Highlands Grand Final live from Mars Stadium.
And there is, I like the kids, have got the old floggers down there. They've custom made, they've found some branches around the back and turned them into a couple of
floggers. Really?
Yeah, they're good on them. Just down, sitting down on the stands there, not hurting anyone.
That's
good on
fantastic.
Them. It is fantastic. So we've gone 14 and a half minutes in this first quarter. One straight goal, Beaufort to 4-1 Hepburn.
Hepburn up on 19 points, Dave. Fairly handy start so far.
Biggest lead the match, I do imagine.
It would have felt that, correct?
Again, Garvey wins that tap out, but the umpires found a free kick for a push. It's stiff when Ogilvie had the ball for Hepburn, it was clear. Garvey handballs it back to his teammate,
goal-scoring Jenkins,
who kicks it long into the forward line. But again, at the fall of the ball was Hepburn, and they're everywhere. Goes one way, out the other. A nice clearing kick into the path of Stanton. Stanton takes the mark, looking for a handball, but turns around. He's got nice yellow boots too, Stanton. That's a beautiful looking boot, that is.
That's give me a kick because I get the footy.
He just lobs a little one in front of Clark. Clark turns around looking. Looks like an old school footballer, Clark. Does a bit of candy on the mark, then kicks it long down the line to a 2-on-1. Both an influencer contest, but now hitting the pack running was Mitch McKay, who chases
it. Great handball.
Handball's out to Clark. Clark Burns. Kicks it in the pass of Burns. Burns goes with one hand, doesn't drag it in. Clearing it now is Beaufort. Beaufort now cleared by the boot of Day. Day into the middle of the ground.
McCorkle.
Hits McCorkle. McCorkle kicks it, but smashed.
Leo Sayer.
As Leo Sayer's killed his Beaufort teammate, but long kick for goal. And a ripping
wow,
kick
that
for goal.
From?
Kicked. I believe it was...
I'm trying to see who that is.
I'm not too sure, but I think it might have been Rupert Sangster. He's kicked the goal.
I'm waiting to check to see who that is. He's not going to turn the way we wanted to turn.
He's the bloke who got...
Stapleton.
Stapleton. He's as hard as a cat's head.
Tommy Stapleton kicking that goal. Fantastic for Beaufort. Yeah. Number three for Beaufort. Which brings the score 4-1-25 Hepburn to 2 straight Beaufort. 16 minutes gone, first term Mars Stadium.
So Jack Duke got absolutely smoked. And there's a bit of push and shove. They're trying to get into him. Santorini's just punching him, elbowing him, cleaning him up. So Jackie Duke, he seems like, sorry, Murray looks like he's Duke, I should say. He's a tough 6-month-old Lucas. He's taking on. Now the ball again is on half forward for Beaufort.
Great pick up.
Great kick off and clearing. Chasing it down is Tom Stapleton. Stapleman taking it. Having a shot for goal, misses his foot, goes back for it, gets swamped in the process. The umpire said, no chance to get rid of it. Stapleton took on three or four opponents then. And his
centre clearance is David scoring, skyrocketing for Hepburn, 5-0 in his first term, 17 minutes gone.
It should have been a free kick to the Hepburn guy for yanking out of the ruck. There's just a kick, just a nothing kick to nowhere, and then kicking him. Oops, the umpire's pulled a free kick, good full advantage, and he does. Mitch McKay stitched his teammate into trouble, which was what in the path of McKay. McKay goes bang,
goal.
Kicks a goal.
Love McKay from 45 metres out, kicks a goal, which brings the score Hepburn 5-1, 31 to both with 2 straight 12, 17 and a half minutes gone, first term.
And the McKay boys, Brad and Mitch, were a part of it.
Dave, I tell you what I'm seeing here in this last 7 to 8 minutes is how quickly Hepburn get it inside their 450 and they score every single time, which is fantastic to see. Beaufort really need to shut that down.
They're just too fluent and going forward. Once they get that break, it is curtains for Beaufort. So they've really got to address the centre clearances because they're getting murdered inside the contest.
They are still 5-0 on that.
So again, so the centre clearance looks like it's McDermott again against Hogan. McDermott wins it again, but the clearance is going to go to the way of Hepburn with Ogilvie getting the ball, handballing it in the path of McKay. McKay from 50, just chips in the path of Cox. Cox plays on. Left foot snap, bouncing, rolling, missing.
Lee Cox there scoring the behind, which makes it 5-2-3-2. 18 and a half minutes gone, first turn.
So now just a little chip kick into the path of Jenkin. Jenkin now in the defensive forward back pocket. Just airs one straight up in the air to no one. McDermott hits McDermott on the head. The umpire said, yep, you hit that and you caught that with your face, mostly, but mostly got repaid anyway. He handballs it back to a terrible kick. Scooped up fantastically with Sangster. Sangster then gets the handball out to Morrow, who attracts the crowd. Morrow back into it again, misses again. Sangster grabs hold of someone. Mitch Jenkins grabs hold of someone. The handball out in front of McKay of the Brad variety. From 50, lets it go. Lee Cox in the square. Defensive punch by Beaufort. Well done.
I'll tell you what, though, the game is turning very much. A lot of inside 50s now for Hepburn.
Yeah, quick kick out.
12-8.
Grabbing the ball is Levi Cox. Levi Cox, not a lot of options. Go for finds a little hit up pass to his teammate just on the half back flank. Frizzick Road side of the stadium. He's got that. He goes down, goes inboard
dish.
To Petrie. Petrie now, not much kick there. There's a little chip pass to Orr if he wants it. He doesn't really bank himself in.
Dan O'Halloran, guys, on the boundary line. He's very, very proper working up the boundaries. A little bit of a niggle with him.
Okay, you'd be proper too if you had 14 blokes piling on top of you. So now Hepburn go forward in front of Burns. Burns loses his feet again. Beaufort come up with the ball, looking one way. Goes the other, underground handball, but goes nowhere to Orr. Orr tries to find it. They've played a free kick. And there's little spot fires breaking out in here, there and everywhere. And Jaden Orr will take the free kick for getting his head.
Free kicks, Hepburn 4-2, Beaufort 3.
And he's not happy to take kicks, so he little stab pass to find Jenkins. Jenkins on the defensive 50, a clearing kick out to McInnes. McInnes goes back, not much to kick to. He now finds his teammate again leading, but that's a terrible kick. McDermott pass it with Brad Duke. Now Mitch Foster has a problem.
Brendan Howe there watching the ball, assisting the ball over the line. Tackles in the first term, both at 11 to Hepburn 10. Very, very tight tussle in that stat. Thanks, Matt.
So McDermott not one in the contest by Watt. Now high ball in the path, but a great, great contested mark taken by Garvey and goes back looking for an option. Not much to kick to. Wants a little hit up lead. That was a very Jim Manson like. Oh, he's kicked it straight over his teammate's head in the path of Wills. Wills saws a bit of trouble one way, the other. But Garvey gets a chance to take the mark again and do something a bit better.
Bit of redemption.
This time, he just hits his teammate and drops the ball in Stapleton. And now he's got a problem. He's got out of trouble.
Turns him inside out.
His hand falls out. I'm not sure he broke the tackle. But now Beaufort had the ball on the outer side wing, but another poor kick. Hits his both head by Halloran right in the middle of the ground. Options are plenty. Kicks it to his teammate and McKay. And McKay will take a set shot directly in front from 40 metres out. And it's Mitch McKay who will take the shot at goal. 40 metres out, directly in front. It should be no issue.
Again, Hepburn inside 50, 15-8 in this first term. 21 and a half minutes gone. With Mitch McKay lining up, as you said, Dave, directly in front, 40 metres out. I tell you what, if he scores this, it makes it very, very tough at Beaufort to just readjust and get back in this game.
With that, this will be 9 scoring shots to 2 in the first quarter. Mitch McKay comes in, leans back on it, touched on the line, no, still in play. Burns grabs it, but rushed through
by Brendan Howard.
Brendan Howard from Beaufort. And now taking a kicking at duties. Looks like it's Damien Day.
Hepburn.
Damien Day kicks it now wide out to Levi Cox. Interception. Taking the mark is Jacob Brown. He'll kick right in the forward pocket. Does the old sneaky. Puts a gain of 5 minutes by walking around the ball.
Give
done
me a
that.
Few more, umpire.
No, Paul. So this is right in the... About 40 metres out.
Right in front of the Beaufort fans.
And they are absolutely giving it to him too. The hill's right in front of the hill. One from the Beaufort stands. You can hear him cheering him on. As we're right behind Brown from Hepburn. As he approaches now, lets it fly from 45. It's a good look, no, going across the face. Cox jumps, misses. Now the ball hits the deck and they've all got a problem. Now both of the balls rattled out of bounds. I thought Cox had his hands all over that.
23 minutes gone in the first term. Hepburn 5-4, 34 to Beaufort 2 straight 12.
23 minutes gone, first term. And Garvey's going to take the ruck contest here. Not too sure who's nominated. Cox is nominated for Hepburn. Bit of massive height advantage, but Cox does well, finds his fun spot. Orr grabs the ball, gets tackled as he grabs it. McDermott tries to kick it off the ground and missed. Now grabbing the ball out is Foster. Foster fires it out wide. Another looking handball to his teammate. He gets absolutely smoked in Horsey.
Umpire pays too high.
Oh, I thought it was a fair. Horsey got absolutely hospitalised then.
Smoked him.
Leo Sayer got him. Sayer Leo Sayer got him.
Asa Leo Usa. We'll go with that, Dave. Sounds good.
Now defensive half for Beaufort as they find a little chip up pass, little 15 metres, just working their way down the outer side wing.
Inside 50's Dave, Hepburn 15 to Beaufort 8.
Now a driving kick to the half forward line for Beaufort. Over the back it goes. Runners are plenty, had options are plenty as he kies it. Long, long misses. Ooh, I thought Beaufort had it. One behind.
First behind for the game to Beaufort, 2-1, 13 to Hepburn's 5-4, 34.
Well, I was a bit up this point. I thought Satriani would have kicked, taken the kick out consistent last time they played. He kicked tubes all night.
Santorini, yes, very true.
He kicked tilts all day long out of the full back, but no.
Yep. Our man, John O'Leansini, down the boundary there, just directing some traffic.
Waving his hand like a crazy man. Just sneaking onto the ground now is Brad McKay. He'll try to sneak this one in for sure. Brad just wanders his way forward. Now a little chip out pass from Hepburn.
Luke Stanton.
With Stanton in a defensive back pocket on the social club side. Or broadcast side of the oval. And he looks to switch it now. He's got a couple of options. He just hits a little one just short, just in right in front of his point, of Beaufort's point post. And Beaufort done well here. They've shut up.
Nothing to go to, is there? Down the line, there's nothing. Matched up everywhere.
Really locked it in.
Umpire calls play on.
So another little chip pass again, only just to 15 metres. And that's again tighter angle, deeper in the outer side wing pocket. Sorry, pocket. Does that make sense?
Just go with it, Dave. Sounds
good. And a long kick now. Just driving, just hit to a target. Garvey went straight through his hands. Probably should have done more with it. A quick handball out in the fast, out in front of Stapleton. Stapleton attracts the crowd, gets smoked. Handballed up to McKay. Here off they go. Hepburn rolling. Handball one, two. Runs into a crunching tackle, which was Michael Watt. And the siren goes for the first quarter. 25 and a half minutes. Hepburn 5-4-34 to Beaufort 2-1-13. And a ripping game of football.
Okay. We'll play another song. We'll play our first song for the game, and we'll come back and review the first term from Mars Day in the 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final here on 99.9.
Living End. What noise?
You mate, the first quarter. The stats for you. What sort of been the standout for you?
Hepburn with their centre clearances, 6 zilch at the moment, so they're dominating in the centre.
Yeah, certainly, thank you for that, mate. With the stats there, it's fantastic to have the sort of availability we've got here at 4CFM.
It is, Sam. Now, Hepburn again, Michael Watt on the tap out and into the path of McKay. McKay manges it, but it goes nowhere. Another clearance now for Beaufort. Tumbling ball inside 450, punched out of the way by Satriani, pumps it before towards the boundary line, chases his own ball. He taps it along, kick off the ground into the path of his teammate in, I think it was Stanton. Stanton now kicks an underground ball but goes only into the path of Beaufort, who drives it long, punishing ball. A one-on-one contest spoilt by Jacob Brown, who now umpires pulled up a high free kick in the big defensive forward pocket. Taking forward pocket for Beaufort, and taking the kick will be Alex Petridish, who is in a deep
pocket. Yeah, knowing Alex like I do, Dave, I reckon he may just sneak this one in. He's a very, very mercurial top kick.
Going down check side, and he's kicked across the face. And
shows how much I know.
Well done. Oh, good work by you. Taking the kick out now would be Watt. Standing mark is Lachlan Murray. I still can't believe that.
Oh, he'll just shut up.
He'll jag that, will he? Yeah, he's almost kicked it into the Lakers over. So he's kicked it. So Watt just punishes it outside 50. A pack forms offhand. Roving the pack was Foster, who pumps it in forward. No one took the mark. Jaden Orr roves it. Handballs it off. Snap for goal is in.
Zaney Thompson
kicks a right footed snap up. A handball out by Jaden Orr. Just what they wanted was both for the first goal. The first quarter, the third, second quarter.
1.5 minutes gone, Hepburn 5-4, 34, leading Beaufort 3-1-19. I think the Windery end, Dave, or the old scoreboard end,
or showground end,
is definitely in favour of the major goal scorers today, which is fantastic because it's fairly close.
That's like it. Both kicked the first goal in the first quarter and they had another five kick against them. So let's just calm down here.
The crowd, crowd's slightly building. It still looks fairly empty for a September Highlands Grand Final, but hopefully it builds during the afternoon.
McDermott versus Watt. McDermott again wins the tap out, but he's not really hitting it to advantage, and his teammates get absolutely smoked. Duke, that was. And now the clearance by Hepburn by McKay, who left-footed ball inside deep 50. Behind was Cox, playing well with his Hepburn opponent. Now the ball bouncing around, bit of razzle-dazzle, handball at the Cox, left foot, snap, missing. Far side.
Not even marking it.
Marking it on the line was Damien Day, who now drives just outside 50. Running into the path is McCorkle. Nothing to kick to, so it has to stop and prop. Offering a little lead is Duke. Duke hits up, just right on true single wing, out of the side. Turns around, little left foot stabby pass. Again, finds his teammate, who's now just moved it forward of their centre wing on the Creswick Road side of the ground, right in front of the corrugation of rugged up supporters out in the far wing. He now just punishes it inside 50. Top of the fair, but grabbing, taking the mark was McKay, who just found the hole. Looking for a switch into to Leo Sayer. And Leo Sayer says, no, keep on going. A little handball over the top now. Handball across. Leo Sayer grabs the ball. Handball back. Taking the ball in full flight. The fish and salmon. Salmon kicks it long in front of Burns, who gets his bodywork in there. And now grabbing the ball is Jenkins. Jenkins skies the ball. In fact, a pack towards missing the ball with a big punch for Stapleton. Now taking the ball and running like a cutdown is Reese, who kicks it with his shin and kicks it out of bounds on the full. Reese had a lot of more time than he really realised and kicked it with his shin and kicked it out of bounds on the full. So 40 metres around from the Beaufort got from the Hepburn goal.
Hepburn 16 tackles to 15 in this game, Dave.
So coming in now, looking for someone to kick to, he's not too sure. Long
switch. Kick.
Really dangerous, but beautiful kick now, right on the arc of the 50, swinging around onto his left foot is Levi Cox. Levi Cox looking for his teammate, who balls it up a little bit in Day. Day looking for the handball at the top, misses, and then just a kick forward by Beaufort. As landed in the arms of Beaufort by the Hepburn teammate, he got made to earn it. He got a knee right to the gob. Santorini. He's got a Beaufort knee planted right and firm in his mouth. There's a bit of push and shove and
Came in Ogilvy.
It's probably the only Ogilvy I know that's got a bit of heart. It's said to the other Ogilvy that does our radio show.
Very true, Dave. 15 points the margin here. 4.5 minutes gone. Beaufort 3-1-19. So Hepburn 5-4-34.
Yeah, boundary throw in true centre wing. Throw in. Watts uses his big frame and gets him out of the way. O'Halloran drags his opponent down, but he's given away the free kick in the process, and Beaufort come up with a free kick for too high. But there's a free kick given away
downfield
by Cayman Ogilvie. He got too excited, and taking the free kick is Jack Duke. Half forward line for Beaufort. Left foot, stabby little kick, but he's just airballed over the top to his teammate, who then goes deep inside the forward line, coming out into the path. Was Chrissy Duke. But his Hepburn opponent, that Hepburn get across and small it over the ground. I'll tell you where he will want the ball to go, isn't it, the showgrounds? Looks like the Quamba took track, the full track out there.
It's like a dog's breakfast over there.
It is terrible. Badgy throwing. And a tap out, one by White's in the path of into Beaufort, who clear it, but no one in particular. Grabbing it is Howard. Howard then finds a teammate.
Or
then another little pass and hitting on the chest and going back and having a look for 45 will be Tim Horsey. So Horsey's going to have to kick this 50 metres.
Tim Haas even.
That's Horsey. I'm going Horsey.
I said Timmy Haas.
No, you have no idea.
Kicking right on 50, Dave.
Oh, that's what I said. So Tim Horsey will kick from right on 50. Leans back. He's coming. Bending. No, not enough. One behind. So 3-2-20 Beaufort to Hepburn. 5-4-34. 6 minutes gone. Second term. And the play's been majority down. Beaufort's in. They just had a couple
correct,
of
correct, which is the Lake Minnere end, Dave. 15 to 16 tackles. Inside 50 is 9 to Hepburn's 15. So Beaufort just creeping up the inside 50s there.
Solid crowd in top of the hill there too.
We've lost the ball.
There's someone's decided they like their ball more than they did. They've pocketed the ball. Someone's got it. Someone's knocked off with the ball. Oh, here it comes.
Lucky there's time on.
Here it comes. Lucky. I thought it might have went in the back.
Kick.
Yeah, he hit it.
I thought it might have went in the back of someone's HQ holding.
Bit of a lull down here, Dave, in the grandstand. We're seeing him very, very quiet. The fans just in a holding pattern at the moment.
A lot of Hepburn people, so I just peer out from the commentary box. A lot of Hepburn people out there.
Center clearances, Beaufort 1 to Hepburn 7, and the ball comes back in. Fantastic kick out of defence for Hepburn.
Billy Johns, I think that was. He kicked that all 60 metres, but it's falling in the arms of Oakford, who just a quick snap out of goal, and taking the mark on his chest is Jakey Duke.
Well kicked, this Jack Duke.
And Jake Duke will go back, tight angle, 10 metres out, on a real, not a tight angle, but it's still going to test him, and he's kicked 50 goals for the year, so he should be reasonably happy with that. He's got a good run-up too, real Ben Brown kind of run-up about him. Real deliberate approach.
Jack Duke, by the way, Dave, just clarifying
that. What did I say?
Jake,
doesn't matter. Oh, he's missed it. That's okay, another one.
Well, he's only 20 metres out and he's missed that.
Can you shut up? That's the second one you must. You said you'll kick that. And then you got his teammate before.
I think you said you kicked that.
He kicked it in the middle of the ball and missed everything.
7.5 minutes gone here at Marsh Stadium. Beaufort 3-3, 21 to Hepburn, 5-4, 34.
So a little chip out pass. And in the back pocket is Jacob Brown. Brown just loads it up and gets it outside 50. But standing tall.
Oh, Reece is having a great game.
Horsey now, lick up handball by both. He comes to McKay. McKay kicks it down the middle of the path into the path of Cox. Cox, front hand to take. Draws a heap to the opponents. Andy McKay kicks it off the ground. Beaufort get it. Sells one. Handball back. Dropped by Beaufort. Turn down. Tackle. Hold the ball. A ripping tackle.
Great tackle.
I think it was a McKay.
It would have been. There's a lot of them out there.
It's a Mitch, I think. Mitch McKay with a rundown tackle, I believe. But I'll stand
Andy
corrected.
Andy McKay will kick it from 20 metres out, slight angle.
He's come up a bit proppy too.
Down the Creswick Road end.
Is it the McKay of the Andy variety?
It is the Andy variety, Dave. I'm very good with my names and numbers.
Oh yeah, sure you are. Just like you've got a predicting globe so you can kick goals and jump.
I reckon he will kick this.
Yeah, Andy McKay. Is any certain person to kick this? He is an absolute superstar, Andy.
Well, the bloke's inside the 10 metres protection zone there, Rob Simmons. Bring that out, please.
Don't get too pedantic, boys. So, now, Andy McKay, strolling in the goal. Just a nice, easy approach and goes bang. A beautiful kick by McKay. And
to keep the goal scorer out, I reckon.
And Hepburn extended lead. 7-6-4-40-3-3-21. 9 minutes gone in the second term.
I'll tell you what, Dave, lots of goal scorers. Goal scorers for Hepburn, Jenkins, Duke and Thompson, all one each. And the goal scorers for Hepburn, Burns, O'Halloran, Cox, McKay, Brown, and now Brad McKay.
Brad McKay. No, that was Andy McKay kicked out.
Andy McKay kicked on.
Yes.
Good.
Thanks, Ryan. I thought you said you were good.
I am.
So, another ball up. Doing the ruck contest is Billy Johns. But a clearance by Beaufort in the path of Thompson. Now the ball bounces around aimlessly, but the handball out. Beautiful handball in the path of Clark. Clark, clearing kick, finds his teammate on the true outer side centre wing. A little bit of camera time for the me, run back and make sure to take a picture.
He
kicks it, pumps it, and all. To the unrealistic attempt, the umpire's called. He touched the ball, and Burns is going to be recipient of it.
Wow, Lee Marshall, very, very stiff there. Aaron Burns, right on 50.
So Burnsy, left foot path into Cox. Tangled legs and Garvey takes the crowd. Cox and his teammate, opponent, tangled legs. Nothing really in it. And the handballs it out to the dish and Petrie.
Jenkins
now takes the mark. Pocket. He's got numbers out on the far side, our commentary side wing. Goes in that part. Floating in front was Thompson, who drops the mark. But handball now to McKay. McKay centering ball. Cox right in the area. Hang on. No. Spoiled. Fall of a ball this time is Brad McKay. Goal! Beautiful kick by Brad McKay.
Fantastic there, which brings Hepburn to 7-4-46 to Beaufort 3-3-21. 11 minutes gone, second term, Marsh Stadium.
On the back of a real, real suspicious free kick.
It was, Dave. I thought Lee Marshall was very, very stiff there from Beaufort. Probably nothing in it. The umpire, you don't want him getting involved too much. Very, very pedantic for my mind.
Yeah, I thought he jumped and got a bit of hand on it, so I thought that was fair for mine, but we're not out there in orange.
Really, we're very true. Tackles are leaving up across the board, 18 apiece. Inside 50s have 20 to Hepburn, 17 to Beaufort.
So it's 7-4-46. It's absolutely...
Now lost the ball again by the looks of it.
It's gone out the back.
Any danger we can sort that out,
can
please?
We get some net? They've got the posts for the nets there. Can you put the net up so the ball doesn't go out the back of the goalkeeper?
We build this million-dollar stadium and we can't even organise the ball.
So they're hunting around for the ball. They've got a replacement agate.
We're on here.
We've got a replacement ball.
We reckon John O'Leary's going through his mind on that day. The underbench there holding the notepad, just really thinking about the game.
He'd probably be thinking, Jesus, I'm a pretty good coach.
That's he probably does. He's got a few tickets on himself.
No, he's a good bloke, John. He's really good with his time.
Very, very good with Hepburn next year, the senior coach out there.
Hopefully. Garvey into the ruck now, doing battle against, well, it looks like it was Burns, but I'm not entirely sure. And the tackle is called holding the ball. I'm not sure how he's put that.
Very stiff.
He had no opportunity.
Hepburn's
pulled up. In, I think it was the fish and salmon who jumped up and gone, how did he pull that one out? Now kick forward to 50, but no one, Halloran grabs the ball, just spirals it forward. Oh! Absolutely smoked by his Hepburn opponent.
Turned him inside. Yeah, he begs in half then.
Yeah, he is not well.
Oh, wow.
He has not moved. Been saying that he's the Hepburn bloke sucking the big ones too. He might have winded himself in the process.
Oh, wow.
But he's not moved. Now the ball is inside Beaufort's 4-50.
They're going to have to go for the stretcher here. Have to.
And now, that's Ali Osayo, Shua Osayo, Ren Osayo's got the ball. Garvey kick hands balls it out into the path of Foster. Foster, chip pass.
Great mark.
And beautiful mark.
Beaufort plays up on his feet. I think it's Levi Cox.
He's right. Now taking shot on goal will be Johnny Mason. We're right behind him here. Perfect angle. He's going to kick from 45. The wind seems to be going across the face of goal. So that's only just about a metre outside right goal post. All my years of experience kicking goals. There he is, coming in with a shot on goal. Bit of a stunner there as well. Runs out of target. Bends it back. Goal! No! Touched on the line. And I'm not sure how the Beaufort bloke's up and about.
Yeah, no, that's not good there.
He's almost got knocked the house, right? But he's back up again.
Sorry, Alex Petrie was the player who got bent in half there. He's trying to get his wind back in the lungs.
Tough customer. So 3-4-22 to 7-4-46, 14 minutes gone. And
there's the tune.
Yes. He's landed in the middle of the Eureka Stadium.
Yes.
McKay giving chase. I think it was up to Mitch, Brad, Andy McGarty. Oh, it was Andy. Andy handballs it back in front of
Reece.
Of Clark. Oh, misses the tart while dropping the mark as Wills scoops it back up, centers the ball, and scooped up in the process was Brown. Brown snaps on goal. Yes! Grabs it.
Jacob Brown for Hepburn getting his first goal of the game. Second goal of the game, sorry, which makes the score Beaufort 3-4-22 to Hepburn 8-4-52. 14 and a half minutes gone, second term, Marsh Stadium, 2017, St John's Grand Final.
That was the tube.
That was great.
The torpedo out of full back was fantastic.
It's very, very underrated there. And of course, our man Leo Sayer, he's always good for it, isn't he? Always good for it.
He kicked that easily 65, 70 metres.
Oh, yeah.
Easily.
Absolutely.
Fantastic.
Got
kick.
Right behind it. At least we found the ball this time after this goal. So back in the centre, 30 points the margin here in favour of Hepburn. Just they really want to bring this back in, Beaufort. Need to get a few more inside 50s.
Tom Godsell against Joshy McDermott.
Goodsell
or Godsell?
Godsell, sorry.
I thought Godsell. I'm the one commentating, I should know. So the ball, the centre clearance in the middle, the ball goes nowhere, and they'll do it all again right in the middle of Mars Stadium, as I should call.
Beaufort tackles 21 to Hepburn's 18. Inside 50 is Beaufort 20 to Hepburn's 21.
Godsell uses his strength, get him out of the way. Tackled as he grabbed it was Foster. The ball was not moved an inch. And the umpire is circling. He's going to pull one here. He's held the ball. Not too sure how you can call holding the ball when you just get swamped as soon as you pick it up. And no genuine attempt. But anyway. So McKay, grab the ball. Fires it inside forward 50. Cox slumming out but misses it. Swooped on it is Beaufort now. He needs to kick it. He kicked it just in time. Picking the ball up is Stanton. Stanton tackled. McKay brushes one. Gets cleaned up as he kicks it. The ball bouncing inside Hepburn's forward 50. O'Halloran grabs the ball. He gets smoked as he has it.
Oh, wow.
The umpire's called play on. The ball's bouncing around, just going nowhere. The umpire's pulled a free kick out for too high.
That's going in the way of Beaufort.
About 3 days later, I'm not too sure how he managed that. So now a switch kick. And there's players aplenty out on the outside wing for Beaufort in the path of Morrow. Morrow drops the ball, handballs it back in front of Garvey. Garvey, a little stabby little kick. He's gone nowhere. He chases back up. That's
well done, Howard. Great chase up.
Howard grabs the ball. But now he's turned it over. Firing it long. He's stamped in the path of Cox.
Oh, touch him on.
And hits the post. One behind. So now they're out.
Oh, wow.
The Beaufort bloke kicks it to himself and misses his own target. And now he's found hits the chest of Foster. Foster, no, the umpire said no, he hadn't finished playing the signal, so he got to do
Alex
that all
Petrie's
again.
Alex Petrie's probably still recovering from being bent in half on St. Dave.
More than likely.
Take that back and retry and do that, mate.
Yeah.
Just pick up to yourself, not that hard.
So they're going to go, they're leaving the forward pocket, the back pocket openings a lot, but Petrie kicks to himself again, kicks out, drives in the outer
great
side wing.
McDermott
goes clunk.
Can mark the ball, McDermott, very good hands.
So he'll push back off the mark and Hepburn file back in their zone. He plays on, just kicks again, just an up and under kick. And spoiling the ball was, I say, a USA. I think it was. No, I don't think it was. I think it was Goodsale. I'm going to ball that name out all day.
Oh, Halloran.
Halloran kicks it, fires it in, and misses Orange. Again.
Eight, scores.
Six.
Scores. Four. 18 minutes gone. Second term. 8-6, 54 to Beaufort. 3-4, 22.
And now he, again, Petri dish, gets it out. Just a little chip kick. The Hepburn are happy to give that kick out. They leave the pockets really open. Just then they roll the zone across and lock it in. Oh, that's a beautiful pass.
Great kick, Petri.
Beautiful pass. They're looking around for options.
Not much happening. Is there? They're very stagnant now.
No, they're very stagnant. But he finds an option. Which is going to watch McDermott. But
Santorini marks.
Yeah, go to tube. He doesn't. Just a little proddy little kick. And on the lead, he finds
Michael Watt,
who, if he thinks he's got the journey, he'll have to kick it all of 55 metres. He hasn't got anything kicked.
He might be having a shot, you know.
Beaufort have got back in numbers. Michael Watt loads up, goes long, top of the square. Grab! A huge pack mark. I don't think it was Cox. Wait for him to get up. There's about 18 blokes on top of him taking the mark right about 15 metres out on the slight angle.
Jacob Brown
in the fence.
Line up for goal number 3, Dave.
He's causing headaches down the forward line.
He's in a little surprise packet today.
Yeah, if the McKays don't get you, the Browns will. Or the Browns don't get the Cox will. So, Brown.
Very hard to win. Jacob Brown getting 37 goals for the season.
Walking in. And straight through the middle, and Hepburn extend their lead further.
And the scores here at Mars Stadium, 19 and a half minutes gone, both at 3-4-22 to Hepburn, 9-6-60.
I'm going to go for this early. If Hepburn kick the next one, it's curtains.
Wow.
It's curtains.
19 and a half minutes gone, Dave,
yeah.
We're going that way.
Yeah, if both don't kick the next one, and Hepburn do, I don't think they can come back.
How do you reckon Ron Brown's going to feel at half time in the both rooms?
I reckon it's.
Do you reckon he'll be tearing a new one?
Yeah, you'd want to do something because his team is not functioning now. He's dropped one back, loosened the fence.
Mr. Torpedo's coming off the ground. Oh, no, he's not. He's foxy.
No, he's not because Hepburn have dropped. Both have dropped the loose one back. Oh, contested mark just outside 450, roping it for Beaufort and snapping on goal, and he gets it.
Chrissy Drew.
Missy Drew kicks the goal. And I'll tell you, they're still in it now. If it went the other way, it would have been all over. Missy Drew gets the goal.
Which makes the scores here 4-4-28 Beaufort to Hepburn 9-6-60. 20 and a half minutes gone. Second term here at Mars Stadium. Bit of push and shove in the 4-50 for Beaufort. Just a little bit of a love tap. You know, boys, just letting you know that they're all here today. Great goal there. As we mentioned before, Dave's mate Leo Sayer has pushed down to the 450.
They're not letting Beaufort have that loose man. They just keep on firing numbers down there to make sure they've got an even contest down there. As the ball now is bouncing around inside the centre square, hand out to Santorini. Santorini kicks it down the middle of the ground. Marquet grabs it on the run. Left-footed kick at goal. Helicopter missing.
Ooh. Oh, thought it would have came back there. Brings the scores Beaufort 4-4-28. To Hepburn 9-7-61, 21 and a half minutes gone.
Long kick out into the path into Lee Marshall. Burns jumped straight into him. Almost a professional free kick, really. Oh,
wow.
That's out of bounds. It's out of bounds by a foot.
No, it wasn't, Dave.
Oh, it was.
It's going to be completely out of line.
Now Garvey goes up for the score by Anscombe. And isn't Garvey know all about it? He's in the Garvey. Around the Garvey.
Tackles, Dave, both at 23 to Hepburn 25. Inside 50s, both at 20 to Hepburn 27.
Beautiful bouncy throwing right in front of us on the grandstand wing. Rose out of the pack was Mitchell, Michael Foster, and handballs across. Link up handball at the path of McCorkle. McCorkle looking for options. Oh, options are plenty. Taking a mark in front of the pack was Zane Thompson. And Zane Thompson will have a shot on goal.
40 metres out, you'd say, Dave. On a slight
35, I'm going. 35,
a bit of mayo.
Nearly directly in front, not a slight angle. Leave the call to me, please. You need to worry about your stats.
Yeah, I love it.
So,
stats are plenty here. Tackles 23-25 in favour of
Pittsburgh. Chance of back-to-back goals for Beaufort, which I don't think had happened today.
No.
So this is to put five on the board and just bridge that gap a bit closer. 22 minutes gone, 22 and a half minutes gone, second turn. Very deliberate approach. Kick on its way. Umpire does not move.
Goal. Great goal, Zane Thompson. Beaufort brings the scores. Hepburn 9-7-61 to Beaufort 5-4-34. 23 minutes gone, second term. The first quarter went 25, Dave.
That's
so
25.
Probably about a minute or two remaining in this second term. I'll tell you what, that rain's holding off, but the clouds are getting a bit darker over here at Marsh Stadium.
And it's chilled off a bit.
Yeah, it has a little bit. We've got the windows open here at
Broadcast Central.
It's a bit brisk.
In the ruck now is Michael Watt against big Joshy McDermott again. Watt and McDermott. Good throw by the umpire. But thumped clear by McDermott. But again, Hepburn get the clearance almost. A clearing kick by Ogilvie. And it just bounces around. And no real clearance as of yet. And the ball now just.
Set of clearances, Dave, as it brings to mind Beaufort 4 to Hepburn 8. Free kicks are in favour of Beaufort, 11-7.
So now, the ball bouncing around, clearance this time by Hepburn as it kicks just out of the pack. Running past the ball was Damien Day, kicking at goal.
Brendan Howard, last line of defence, great
Brendan Howard now, he kicks it out. His teammate's got acres of space, one bounce.
Aaron Burns in chase.
Could have had another bounce, but ends up kicking it, then kicks it all the way down.
Oh, no, you're not paying that fire.
Hide it down the ground. Now, Jamie's got the brace and bits.
That is a disgrace.
And the beneficiary is going to be the Petri dish in front of Daniel Rees.
I'm not really biased, but that is a poor decision by the umpire. It's in play.
So the Petri dish kicks it long. Clunking the ball with Tommy Haas. It's Halls.
Halls. Halls.
Now, Jackie Duke goes for the ball. Score
going
away, off hands. Boundary throwing 10 metres around from the Beaufort goal in front of the refreshment drinking hill.
Yes, the station.
The station.
24 and a half minutes gone. Beaufort 5
won't go
24.
Much longer.
Hepburn 9-7-61.
Beaufort can get a goal out of this. I think they've found a free kick. They're going to war for Hepburn over the shoulder. And they're on again. A bit of a frostbite fire again. Push to shove. Jack Duke's trying to take on two of them. And now the clearance, handball out by Ogilvie. Ogilvie finds his teammate in Stanton. Stanton down the wing, hits up his mate in Burns, I think it was, or Clark. Clark now again, running onto it was Ogilvie again. He'll edit true centre wing, out of side of the ground. Stanton kicked on running again, he has the ball. He hits a little loopy pass in front of Burns, who falls just short. And lucky not to go out of bounds in the full. And the ball now nestled inside Hepburn's forward 50 for 35 metres around, out of side, Selkirk's end, Selkirk's side,
yes.
Magic Road side, Brickmaker's work side.
Crescent Road end.
You just name whatever side, maybe that Soldiers Hill side, maybe we can go with as well.
Ooh.
But anyway, the ball cleared by Hepburn, Beaufort just tackled as he kicked it and skewed off the side of the boot.
Alan Ware.
Ware, he picks it up, turns it over, and link up handball. Now kicking it long was Mason. Mason, oh, and they're off to races. Michael Foster, he's kicked it beautifully. The one bounce could have had a good run. Chrissy Drew, goal!
Great goal, Beaufort, great goal.
And then right back into it.
26 and a half minutes gone. Hepburn 9-7-61 to Beaufort, 6-4, 40, second term, Mars Stadium, 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final.
So whatever Clan said that was almost curtains was an idiot, pretty much.
Oh, absolutely, Dave. And I reckon that might have been you idiot.
We're not going to name names.
Starts with D. McBain.
Yeah,
and that is you.
His initials was Dave McBain. Go with that.
But anyway. I tell you what, Dave, it's a very, very classy game of football here. Only 21 points to margin in favour of Hepburn. Oh, I feel like it's going to be a massive second half.
Yes, I don't think that. And now almost another clearance in Foster. He tries to get the ball, gets his. Almost got his little Chinese burn kind of tackle, little chicken wing kind of setup.
Little chicken wing, you're going with that one.
Little chicken wing, he's not happy about it either. He's taking a while to get up. He's up to his feet now and he's hobbling around as well. He's limping as well, so he might have got his ankle caught. Now McDermott doing battle again. Clearance in that now by Beaufort, which is Mitchell Jenkins, who misses the ball completely.
Cayman Ogilvie,
who has support from Stanton. Cayman Ogilvie kicks it long to a 2-on-1. And buttering up down there is the Petrie dish again, who seems to be everywhere. Petrie.
Alex Petrie getting a lot of footy today. That getting bent in half in that early this term is.
Might have sprited him up.
It might have given him a bit of peppity step.
Might have been
27
like,
and a half minutes gone here at Mars Stadium.
Might have been like a good cup of coffee. Getting smoked. Just woke him up. So anyway, the ball, top of the 50 for Hepburn. Little chip kick in front of Burns!
Right, Mark.
Oh, Burns great takes the mark.
Directly in front of goal down the Crescent Road end, Dave. Hepburn, 21 points up, 28 minutes gone. Second term, Stadium. Should kick the goal, you would have thought.
Oh, they'll miss it now.
Yeah.
You said that.
I've really stitched them up today.
Nothing more certain than that will happen.
Not really going well today, I would have thought.
Oh, yeah. Pretty odd then, to be honest.
Yeah.
So, Burns, I'm really impressed with his top knot.
The bun's really cool, isn't it?
Really
I like that.
Tight.
He
really
wears
tight.
It well.
So, left foot. Real deliberate approach, and there's a shock, he missed it, Jamie.
Stitched him
up. A bit different.
Stitched him up, 28 and a half minutes gone. Beaufort 6-4, 40 to Hepburn 9-8, 62.
Beaufort do well just to get this as far as
Brendan
away Howard. As I can. Brendan Howard gets it to the 50. A huge fly, both team a handball out to McDermott. McDermott didn't want no the case buzzing around there as well. And there's the siren at half time. Quarter gone, 28 minutes, 41 seconds. And
Beaufort 6-4-40. We'll do a tussle down here at half time to Hepburn 9-8-62. The umpire is
there's a bit of a push and shove. Don't get
just
too excited.
Just sort him out here.
A bit of push and shove. Garvey's in there throwing his big praying mantis
just
arms around.
Just to sort this out, umpires. Let the boys just wander off. Let's just sort it out, guys.
Just a bit of push and shove there. Praying mantis.
Garvey's. So 22 points here at half time. The 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final. Beaufort, as we said, 6-4-40 to Hepburn, 9-8-62. 22 points to margin. We'll be back very shortly to review the first half here on 99.9
Screaming Jets.
Boys FM.
At the
Last-minute decision.
That's an ordinary performance.
I'll tell you what, so we're really looking forward to a cracking second half here at Marge Stadium. 22 points to margin in favour of Hepburn, 9-8-62. Beaufort 6-4-40. As Matt mentioned earlier, Jacob Brand in 3 goals so far for Hepburn, and the major goal scorers for Beaufort is Zane Thompson and Chrissy Drew, both with 2 apiece. Jono and Jason Oliver walking off the ground into their coaching positions. Very, very focused. Jono, just letting Jason know that I'm about here, and I think we should do it this way.
Yeah.
Jono with his lovely footy and his beanie, just really rocking the country bumpkin.
Love it.
The boy from Lau Lau.
Loving it. So they're now taking their positions out. We'll open the window again for the effects because it's nothing better. But I tell you, it has dropped off a couple of degrees.
It has dropped off a little degree. I might just chuck the vest on. I've got a bit of ice just across the chest of mine. Matt, so you're your first time up in Ballarat here at the Central Highlands Football League Grand Final. How have you found it so far, and what's been the most exciting part?
The atmosphere. It's plenty of people in here, and this stadium is terrific.
Very, very good, isn't it? The AFL venue that they've done here in Ballarat. So. Besides that, what about the weather? How do you find that?
I'm not a fan of the weather down here. It's a bit too chilly. Dropped off about 6 degrees on the way up here.
It has, doesn't it? Yeah, we're watching the temperature of the car just very, very much fade away, Dave.
I guess it was okay up in Molly, wasn't it? Don't give me
so the players and
that's
umpires in position.
Still like this.
Players and umpires in position, ready to go here for the second half.
Don't change this up.
22 please. Points the margin in favour of Hepburn. Let's now cross to our major caller, Dave.
Umpires. He's just got us ready to go. Siren should be ready. Here we go. We're up and about. The umpire, McDermott, doing battle for Beaufort. We're thrown by the umpire. McDermott wins a tap again. Beautiful tap down to McCorkle. McCorkle fires it in. Ooh, pack forms. Big hit of the pack with Zane Thompson. Off hands, back into the middle of the ground again. The Hepburn opponent attracts a crowd, and the umpire says, I'll have it. It looks like Santorini might be out there. He looks like a little bit sore. He might have got a little stinger in that pack then. He's holding a winged right arm. Again, McDermott wins the tap again, but rove by Hepburn, but fails to take full advantage. The umpire says, no, we'll do it all again. So it's again, looks like it's proceedings to start off. They did like the first half.
Slow and stagnant, I thought.
Yeah, it's really slow. So off again, McDermott didn't win that contest. Then McCorkle thumps it out of there. A fresh air. McKay grabs the ball, kicks it, and up and under the ball. Gets playing stand on that play there. Marking the ball, but called play on was Ogilvy. Fires it out the handball, and away they go now. And Hepburn, McKay fires it in, but he kicks it straight down the throat of Zach Morrow. And Morrow now has got plenty of options. He drives the ball long to Stanton from Hepburn, just standing there all by himself.
Just picked him out nicely, didn't he?
Beautiful pass to Stanton. So Stanton in his nice flashy yellow boots hits the chest of Clark. Clark turns around and fires one on for the chest. Play on. No, the umpire's called play on. Not sure what's happened there, the umpire said. No, I'll have it. I'm not too sure why it was called. When Brown thought he had it, Brown thought, yeah, I'll take that mark.
He did balk Dave, so it's probably a good call there by Steve McConville.
So ruck contest. O'Halloran grabs the ball, right-footed, snap for goal!
Look at that.
Yes! Lifting shot from goal on the boundary line. And it was a
O'Halloran, that does not happen, please. Put that away. Remember, you're in Ballarat playing local footy. Scores are 2 minutes into the third term, sorry. Hepburn, 10-8, 68 to Beaufort, 6-4, 40. Dave, you may be on the verge of calling this one, I would have thought.
Helen's almost gone. Eddie Betts.
That doesn't happen, please. That does not happen here at local football.
Bending it away from goal. That was a ripping effort. Ripping effort by
Just shows home. The experience right there.
He has to do that another 10 times and miss it every single time. But it doesn't matter. He's done in the grand final. Good on him. McDermott wins the tap out. Smashes in the face of his teammate in Stapleton. Now bouncing around. Clearance by McKay. Kicks it into their forward line. One-on-one. Brown rows the back. Runs onto it. Taps to himself, tackled, threw the ball out, but the umpire plays play on. Zach Morrow clears it for Beaufort at the inside wing, and it goes nowhere in particular, out of bounds or a throw-in.
Daniel Rees for Hepburn is playing fantastic across both wings. He's got a lot of the footy, and he seems to be at the end of every single pass outside of their attacking 50.
So boundary throwing right on the arc of the 50 metre for Hepburn. Herbert, back by Jack Duke, to his teammate who got smashed. And McKay kicks it forward, but out of bounds on the full in front of the fancy scoreboard, and Beaufort will take the free kick.
3 minutes gone, margin 28 in favour of Hepburn.
So, out of options really. So, Beaufort just kick it long down the line. It's flying from behind and taking a great grab. Not sure that was a Duke of some description. I'm not too sure, but he's played on left foot penetrating further down the line. Hepburn in, looks like it was where he threw up, hit the ball, missed it, but his teammate gathered it, kicks it further down the line. But marking the ball in the middle was Sangster. Digby Sangster has the ball on half back. Steady.
Levi Cox.
Debbie, who was that? Who kicked Levi Cox?
Yep, Levi Cox gets it now, goes through centre.
Levi Cox, then McKay bounces it up. He misleaves the ball behind, wide handball out in the front of Orr links it up to Morrow. Morrow kicks it over the top in the path of Lockie Murray, but a beautiful start, but Lockie Murray grabs it again, snaps the goal and misses.
Which brings the score here, 4 minutes gone, third term, Hepburn 10-8-68 to Beaufort 6-5-41.
So, with the kick-out duty for Hepburn, it is Anscombe. Really uncork a talk. You like my little rhyming slang there? Little rhyming turned into a rapper. Here he goes. Long kick out to our broadcast wing. Looking flying was McDermott. Off hands. The ball bouncing. Quick kick out. Taken by Thompson. Thompson centre clearance, but straight to Satriani. Satriani now to Stanton. Stanton switches the ball. Oh, there's both an opponent. Reeves runs past it, giving chase to Jack Duke. Jack Reese takes one bounce, kicks it further afield, but to no one in particular, taking it on the chest is Sangster again.
Levi Cox.
This is Digby Sangster.
16 Levi Cox.
No, it does 18. Digby Sangster. You've got no idea. And no, now the ball is smothered by Hepburn. They're off again. Out in the path now of Brad McKay. Brad McKay gives a little handball over the Cox. Cox wheels around, left hand, handballs it back to McKay. McKay overruns him. Cox dives on the ball. And it's thumped out again. Taking it again is Reese. Reese one way goes, the other handballs inboard, but the ball is now out of bounds.
Well, very late call for the umpire. That was well inside the ground before he even called that.
Well, interesting. It was the furthest boundary umpire away.
It was 5.5 minutes gone, third term. Beaufort 6-5, 41. Hepburn 10-8, 68. Margie 27 points.
Another good boundary throwing. McDermott is dominating the ruck contest. Getting no reward. Now, umpire said that ball's going nowhere and we'll throw it in. Thanks.
Throw it up. I'll
throw it up as well. So,
there's a bit of love in the crowd again. No real fans.
No action, spoken. Really. So, clearance now. It did run a long way.
Aaron Burns, great
clearance. Here, barks the ball 10 metres out in a slight angle.
I tell you what, he's a direct opponent there from Beaufort. Gave him a little bit and he just took it all, didn't he?
Stamping under the real white. Real shiny boots. Not a bad little setup there.
Tackles Beaufort 35 to Hepburn 33 as Aaron Burns lines up for goal.
There's a great kick by Caden Overly and Burns goes bang.
Great goal right
through the middle.
Brings the score to Hepburn 11-8, 74 to Beaufort 6-5, 41. 6.5 minutes gone, third term. Thanks to our radio sponsor, KHP.
So 33 points of differential.
I tell you what, it's just sort of creeping out a little bit now, which we don't want to sort of a game that's going to, just going to be boring in the last term, do we?
We'll spice it up.
We'll spice it up.
We'll be right. So, McDermott, do battle again against Godsell, I think it is. Let's have to stand there, mate. We'll tap to you. But Godsell, I think it was Michael Watt was who was the boundary, but now the clearance by McCorkle kicks it long to Garvey. Garvey gets hands on it, bundles up his own possession, gets smoked in the process. Quick snap by Morrow, was it goal?
Timmy Haas.
Timmy Horsey, was it?
Timmy Haas, yeah.
Timmy Horsey kicked the goal. It's like Renaspin, Renault.
It's not how you say his last name, surely.
I played golf.
7.5 minutes gone, Hepburn 11-8, 74 to Beaufort 7-5, 47. Cool.
Horsey family,
seven
who play golf
at
Midlands Golf Club here in Ballarat, and a fantastic golfing family. One of their sons has just gone to America. He plays off plus two.
Really?
As a scholarship.
Interesting fact.
They're called Horsey, and they stay the same way.
So 27 points of difference in favour of Hepburn.
So another clearance by McCorkle, who kicks it long again. Leo Sayer missed the ball, turn around, and with the ball was Thompson. Thompson hits on the chest of Tim Horsey. And he'll have a shot for goal again.
Great clearance there by Beaufort. Straight into the attacking 50. And hopefully, if they score this, Dave, we might just have to bring this game back into balance here. Because I tell you what, it's just swinging a little bit, just quietly.
So here we go. Tim Horsey. Coming in for a kick.
Oh, you love it, don't you?
It is. A very deliberate approach. Running in. Kicks the ball. Bent-legged action. And he's got the distance and got the goal. Back-to-back goals for Beaufort, exactly what they needed.
Back-to-back goals for Tim Horsey.
And the scoreboard, 8-5-53, Beaufort 2, Hepburn 11-8-74. And they just find a little bit of momentum again, Beaufort.
Tell you what, this is getting very, very difficult now, Dave. It's 21 points the margin in favour of Hepburn. I tell you what, another goal, it just swings it a little bit, doesn't it?
It does.
I tell you what, it's exciting second half. Very, very pumped.
It is. German again in the ruck. He's winning the ruck contest.
Against Michael Watt.
Running ruck contest. Watt done a fantastic tap out to his teammate in the fish and salmon be left behind. And Beaufort bloke got his head.
Jared McCorkle's down. He's not.
No,
he's
up now.
Not in a good way.
He's up now. He's not shiny boots. He'll get up. McCorkle up he gets. Yeah, and he's right.
Should the wind taken
in? Checking his jaw to make sure it's still attached. Ruck contest won by Hepburn. The Beaufort bloke tries to clear it. He's dropped the agate. The umpire says no play on. Oh. Releasing handball by Beaufort. Then they just kick. A hip, I should say. And up and under ball. Stand on that. Play for Jacob Brown, who's doing his best to be best on ground, I'd imagine.
Played a very good game so far.
Takes a great grab.
centre wing, broadside, broadcast wing, long ball in the path of taking the mark was Jackson Hogan.
Hogan's also played a great game, Dave.
Oh, we've got a little bit of cramp too. Both Beaufort is played on because his calves are going to explode.
Terrible kick.
Hit all shit. But the ball now bouncing in front of Tanner Wells. Snap, misses.
Ooh. Jeez, I'll tell you what, Dave. 10 minutes gone, third term. Beaufort 8-5-53. Hepburn 11-9-75. Margins 22 points.
Beaufort long kick out to Garvey direction. Off hands, rove by Rees. Rees on 40, kicks a goal.
Does deserve a goal.
Nails it.
Does deserve a goal. Daniel Rees scores.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful kick for goal, Reesy.
I'll tell you what, he has played a fantastic game. He's also in favour for best on. 10.5 minutes gone, third term here at Mars Stadium. Beaufort 8-5-53. Hepburn 12-9-81. I tell you what, Dave, it's a seesaw battle at the moment. We're not quite sure who's going to take the upper hand, who's going to be the first turn to break.
I don't know. It's hard. I can't say much because I called it over at 10 minutes in the second quarter.
That's how good you're going.
So I've got no idea.
The stats are very even across the board. Tackles 35 to 33 in favour of Beaufort. They're just squaring it up now.
Amon Ogilvy was very late on getting on the ground, so Hepburn went with one less in this in the clearance end.
That's not a good thing.
Lucky to get
inside 50s are squared up, 34 apiece. Very, very interesting, Dave.
Godsell grabbed out of the ruck. Quick kick out to the outside wing. Beautiful bounce for Rees, who gets a bit of a chuck. But the umpire says no play on, got loose contact. McDermott tries to punch it and got half of a Hepburn play at the same time. A tackle applied. The umpire said no, we'll have it just opposite the centre circle, right in the middle of Mars Stadium.
11 and a half minutes gone. Difference is 28 points in favour of Hepburn. This game all squared up.
Godsell and McDermott do battle. McDermott wanted to tap again. Wrapping it up and handballing out quickly was Jenkins, who then fires it in the path of Stapleton, who kicks it long and taking a grab almost on his chest was Howard, who fumbles the ball. Quick snap, a goal, bouncing, missing.
Zane Thompson there had a crack from just really in line with the goals and he bounces through for a behind. Brings the score to 8-6-54. Hepburn 12-9-81.
Long kick out of defence by Hepburn and Brown again taking a one handed grab. Brown has it on the string today. Now he just kicks an up and under kick and Butter Burns flies, misses the ball. And then attracting a crowd was Hogan. Hogan gets thrown over the ball, then running the ball over. It was Chrissy Jew. We'll have a boundary throw in right in front of us. Broadcast wing. Yeah, looks like a bit of a push and shove
bit of piffo here on centre wing in front of our commentary box.
Garvey will take the ruck contest. Garvey do battle, no one in particular. Ridden like a surfboard was Godsell, but he continues playing. Now the ball's
Brad McKay.
In Brad McKay. Ooh,
good tackle, beautiful. Great tackle. Don't worry about that, get the free kick, tackled by McKay.
Goes back.
Chrissy Drew's not happy at all with that.
He's filthed up a bit. And McKay, right, he's going to kick this 55. He thinks he's got the distance.
Does he kick it, Dave? Distance-wise?
Not sure if he's got the leg unless he uncorks or talk.
The tube?
There's a tube, but we'll see what happens. He backs himself in unless he's going to hit a little one to the top of the square. Kicks it. 52 metres. Gives it everything he's got. Just short. Sport right on the line, a ripping kick.
Third 10.5 minutes gone, third term. Beaufort 8-6-54 to Hepburn 12-10-82. Brings the margin to 28 points.
A kick in front of McDermott, back in the hands of McKay. McKay sells a bit of hand candy. Then a quick kick by Joe Clark. Clark off hands in the front of Burns. Burns is waiting down the back like a seagull on a ship.
Need to be clean here, Beaufort.
But no, Beaufort's running with the ball. Looking like a rugby drive style. Getting the ball out of the pack and quick snap of Gaze. McKay not bending enough. And it'll go through for one behind. So it's 14 minutes gone. Hepburn 8-6-54.
Really poised this game. Really poised.
12-11-84-83 to Beaufort 8-6-54. Big long kick down the middle.
Brendan Howard.
Howard, but grabbing it was McCorkle who kicks it. Just a mongrel kick down the line.
Richard Jenkins
in an arm race against... USA Leo Sayer. But he's still going at it.
Great
beautiful guy.
Effort.
Kick kick a goal on the way by Jaden. Oh, marked on the line. Reece saves the day.
Oh, Daniel Reece had a cracking game.
Oh, and then missed a tenth by Alan Ware. And then they fight Beaufort now. Find it.
Tommy Stapleton inside 50 to Jaden Orr.
Jaden Orr, who will kick. He has to kick on 50, who kicks a little kick now to McCorkle.
Don't know about the distance.
McCorkle is hit. Jaden Orr's kicked at 6.8 metres.
Very, very short.
Jaden McCorkle.
The umpire was right on the spot.
I'd say he wouldn't like to buy land off him.
15 and a half minutes gone with Beaufort lining up for goal. 8-6-54 Beaufort, Hepburn 12-11-83.
So I'd say
Beaufort really do need this goal just to bring this back, game back a bit.
McCorkle. Here he goes, he's on the runway. He's going to kick it from 50 right on the paint. Leans back, has it got the journey?
Great
it
kick.
Has!
Great kick, McCorkle.
Great kick, Cameron McCorkle.
Jared.
You know, Cameron, this sounds like the race car driver.
Brings the score 9-6-60 to Hepburn, 12-11-83. 16 minutes gone, third term, with some very interesting stats today still coming out of this game. It's all very poised, all very even across the board.
Tell us what that is. Mention a couple.
Okay, I'll mention a couple. We've got tackles 41-43 in favour of Hepburn, inside 50, 37 apiece. Centre clearances has crept up a little bit. Hepburn 13 to Beaufort 7.
So the ball up, rounded at the feet is out the ruckman, and the ball is still inside the big centre circle.
I tell you what, Dave, we've got the window open here, just hear some effects, but the smell coming up into this box is making me extremely hungry.
The Corkle almost had a clearance and left the ball behind. Yeah, turning one way and the other was Sangster, who ran himself into trouble. Yeah, here we go, it looks like McKay has got the ball. He fires on goal, long kick of goal. McDermott touches it on the line.
Quick play. Jaden Orr.
Jaden Orr, right in the arc of 50. Handball, quick release handball.
Petrie.
The dish. Petrie. Too wide, and too far, and nothing Zach Morrow could do.
Three kicks in favour of Beaufort, 12-8, with 17 minutes gone. Third term, Beaufort 9-6-60, Hepburn 12-12-84.
I tell you, it hasn't been sighted. He must have really caught that knee in the back of the head to Jared Tweed. Has not been signed.
No, you're correct, Dave. How did you come back on the ground too?
The ball gets over the back of the ruckman, tackled as he kicked it, but in the mark, taking the mark was Levi Cox. Cox has got a target in the middle of the ground. He hits that up and turning as Tommy Stapleton. Stapleton wide, leaping handball.
Brendan Howard.
To Howard. Howard is ambling along. Little chip pass again, wider again, still on the outside wing. Now driving it forward inside the Ford 50. A pack forms. Usaya Osaya, Ray Osaya punches the ball away, but roving the pack.
Centurini
just kicks an high ball, and marking the ball with Alex Petrie. Petrie, he's got a heap of Hepburn numbers to deal with, kicking the ball in the path of
Jenkins.
Handball, has the handball to Stapleton. Stapleton, no, sorry, not Stapleton.
Oh,
Murray.
Come round.
Murray. Oh, bouncing, still in play. Satrini, handball across out to Reece. Reece fumbles it, but gathers it. Now a nice looping handball to his teammate, who then handballs inboard, who runs past the ball, swooping on it, kicking a goal! Yes!
Wow! Rupert Sangster gets the goal for Beaufort.
The Sangster gangster
brings the score. Hepburn 12-12-84 to Beaufort 10-6-66. 19 minutes gone, third term. Wowee, Dave. Game on. Game on.
Yeah, this next one. Not yet.
Get excited, Beaufort fans, for tuning in. Back home there, the boys are coming.
Last town on Ohio between Adelaide and Melbourne.
Only you would know that.
Yeah, so I've gone from Beaufort to Melbourne. There's not another town on the map.
Unit, Dave.
Really. Another clearance by Beaufort. In a part of Jack Duke. Asaya Lewisaya flies up and spoils it. Trying to run is Tim Horsey. Horsey, he's got a Jack Capone McKay, kicks it off the ground, chasing it down.
Deliberate umpire, are you going to pay it?
Is Luke Tom Stapleton and umpire.
Good call. No, 19 and a half minutes gone, third term here at Marsh Stadium. Beaufort 10-6-66 to Hepburn 12-12-84. Three goals the margin.
Boundary throw in. The ball gets ripped out. McCorkle, who's played a great third quarter, called his name all the time.
He kicks the ball into a pack. The umpire's just looking. He said, no, that's not coming out of there. The ball situated half forward, outside wing.
Inside 50s now are moved up in favour of Beaufort. 40 inside 50s to 38. Dave, I'm telling you, the stats are saying the game is swinging slightly.
Garvey wins the tap out and quick
right
kick.
Tap.
Marking the ball is... Ooh, was it a Sangster?
It's Zach Morrow.
Oh, Zach Morrow. I thought it was a Sangster. It was like calling the name Sangster.
It sounds like gangster, but it's not. So,
well,
I'll say it.
But that's all. So, Zach Morrow.
Will kick from 40 metres out down the Creswick Road end to make it two goals, Dave. This will make it two goals.
Yeah, you might be the only one wearing a long sleeve today, actually.
Please fill in your apology at the front door, please.
Might be the only one out there. So he comes in, kick it, goal. Doesn't like it at all. He does. Beautiful kick.
Boy, oh boy, here it comes.
Here they come. 11-6, 72 to Hepburn. 12-12, 84. 12 points of differential. 21 minutes gone, third quarter.
We have got a game on here at Mars Stadium.
I think I called the game was still up and about.
No, I didn't.
They're up and about, the Beaufort boys. The Hepburn crowd, which the majority in front of us, have gone
awfully quiet. Centre clearances in favour of Hepburn still, 13-8. And slowly,
go.
The sun's out here at Mars Stadium. We're turning it on here at 99.94 FM.
The sun's broken out. Ooh. And the ball's bouncing around. McDermott fires out the handballs. And then running out of trouble with Stapleton. And then hands it back to Orr. Oh, quick kick out.
Oh,
misses
here we
the
go.
Target. Roving the pack. Shot at goal. Misses.
Missed there. Jackie Duke needs to get the range sorted out there. Should have kicked that.
Duke, I thought was
needed to kick that.
Yeah, he's back inside two goals now. A quick firing kick out and almost taking the mark out there was...
Cayman Ogilvie,
I think. I'm not sure
it was. How good does the sun look bellowing down onto the stadium,
Dave?
Like
Cayman Ogilvie has really bright boots.
Does he?
Yeah,
really,
that's how much attention you've been paying.
I'll tell you who's gone quiet for Hepburn, and that's Aaron Burns. He's barely got the ball this quarter. Needs to probably turn that around.
Maybe.
Daniel Rees, though, gets it again. Kicks it down to...
Left footed kick.
Centre wing.
Straight down the throat of Chrissy Drew. Chrissy Drew now looking for options. He's got a couple short.
Experience campaigning, Chrissy Drew.
He's now kicked it just long down the line. Over the head of his opponent and over out of bounds for a boundary throw in.
Jackie Duke
70 metres around from the Beaufort goal.
11 points of margin here at Mars Stadium. 22 and a half minutes gone, third term.
So it's been a ripping quarter. So it's been a 3-goal to 5-goal quarter in favour of Beaufort. The ball fired into the Beaufort's forward line. Ains up. Taking the grab is Lachlan Murray. And this is to get it within a kick. Within a kick. You had it written off.
You had it written off.
No, I'm going to put it on you.
23 minutes gone, third term here at Marsh Stadium. The 2017 Central
Kick of no
final.
More than 30 metres. Lachlan Murray's kicked 50 plus goals for the year.
He has indeed.
None of them count more than this one right now. He needs to kick this one. The momentum is with him to go to get within the side of kick and have a heap of momentum. Left foot. Kicks it. Locks it. And it's gone.
Right,
Murray kicks the goal. Back to 5 points.
5 points. Hasn't even been to 5 points. Get around him.
12-7, 79 Beaufort to Hepburn. 12-12, 84. 23 and a half minutes gone. Third quarter.
I'll tell you what, Dave.
And the Hepburn bench is looking around going, what do we do?
Jono looking and just pondering what to do next.
What to do.
So inside 50s in favour of Hepburn still. 48 to 43.
Here we
so
go.
38 to 43 in favour of Beaufort. So sure. Game,
your
really turning here, Dave.
Your mate, the umpire.
Stephen McConville.
Yeah. Big try. McDermott wins the tap out again. Another clearance. Oh, streaking away and handballing it in front of Stapleton. Stapleton misses it. Got tackled too high by almost one McCabe. But no, the umpire said no.
Good call. Biffo here. There's just a bit of niggle in the game now.
Stapleton really needed to release that quickly.
Margin 5 points here, third term.
That umpire again, ball up and it's going nowhere again.
In favour of Hepburn, major goal scorers, Jacob Brown, 3 goals. Beaufort cheering him around, Zane Thompson, Timmy Haas and Chrissy Drew.
Clearance
all
by
twos.
Stanton. Bounces one way, going the other, all fast, couple of players, but roving it and getting the handball out quickly was Levi Cox, a quick snap around the corner. And now centre clearance too high. The umpire, he ducked his head. He's played on. Now he gets one in the back as well, and he's ridden him like a surfboard. The umpire said, "No, we just let it play like it should be in grand finals."
Correct. 25 minutes gone here. Third term, Mars Stadium. Hepburn up by 5 points. That's right, 5 points.
And the quarter goes 25 on the knocker. So it's Hepburn 12-12-84. Beaufort 12-7-79. 5 points the difference. All the momentum with Beaufort in the last quarter. This is shaping up to be a ripping, ripping grand final.
It is indeed, Dave. It is indeed. We'll play some tune and be back with the review of the third term. I tell you what, we're excited. Last quarter coming up right after this.
George Edra, Budapest.
Matrix are not permitted on the playing surface.
And this is shaping up to be an absolute ripping.
We'll run through the major goal scorers for Hepburn. Jacob Brown, 3 goals. Dan O'Halloran, Brad McKay, Aaron Burns, all scoring 2. And for Beaufort, Zane Thompson, Timmy Hawes and Chrissy Drew, all 2 goals. As the crowd is erupting here at Mars Stadium. Dave, final quarter, across to you.
There we go. The umpire. There's a little bit of camera time too. We're ready to rock and roll. This final game, final quarter of 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final. Beaufort Hepburn doing battle, and thanks to our station sponsor NHP, who are doing a ripping company. Ball up in the square, one down by the Hepburn counterpart, but it's tackled as soon as he gets it. A ball up straight away, and Garvey into the ruck. Who McDermott dominated that third quarter ruck contest.
Indeed.
So now doing battle, looks like it's Michael White against Garvey. Garvey wins it majorly. O'Halloran in there diving in hard as always. Stanton grabbing the ball, stumbling, can't take it. Out to McCarson, Reese. Reese has a look, left footed kick. Cox on the lead, grabs it! And he's hurt himself too, Cox. He got smoked. The Cox. And here to the goal, this is it.
I'll tell you what, Dave, really, really.
In front of the social club. Grant on, he's going to have to kick it from 45.
He's tight angle. 11 points in favour of Hepburn.
Tight angle. He's stretching his calf a little bit. And they're having a little bit of stretch of the legs. Here he comes. The premier kill kicker in the Central Highlands Football League. Comes in very direct approach. Kicks it from 45. Up and under. Bending, bending. Missing near side. Goal the difference here at Mars Stadium. And it's 12-13-85, 12-7-79, Beaufort gone just inside, outside a minute, last turn. And a nice little, quick little kick out to Jack Duke, who marks it in his own defensive 50,
really
40 metres out.
Jack Duke, he's inside the defensive, he's
going to
kick.
He's going to kick his left foot, going to switch. Finds his teammate on the other side wing. And he's avenue out, got locked up pretty quick. Now, looking on the other side wing, there is Brandon Howard, who... He's done himself in a mischief here, but he's turned himself in, kicked fast, and it hits on the chest of Chrissy Drew. Chrissy Drew now looking for an option, all avenues tied up, kicking long down the line. Garvey in, but floating in front of him was Alan Ware. And Ware plays on, drives it long into the 450. Brown in the way, off hands, Beaufort now grab it, handball out again now. With Sangster kicks it, ran past the Stapleton, rise to tackle the Stapleton, too high, says the tackle. And Zane Thompson tackled O'Halloran around the head. O'Halloran got up a bit properly, but he'll be right. He's tough, a 6-month-old licorice O'Halloran.
Don't worry about that. Do you know trust the Hepburn on the bench? Just really calling out to his players, wanting more from him.
O'Halloran fires it in, Howard misses the ball, hitting the deck and roping it is McKay, snap, goal, missing.
Really need to kick that goal, Mitch McKay.
Beautiful bit of roving by Mitch McKay, though.
7 points of margin in favour of Hepburn. Just quick holding
kick
on here.
Quick kick out. Hepburn really applying the pressure this so far. The ball has not seen Beaufort's inside a forward 50 at the moment. Another long kick out in front to McDermott. McDermott, Ware flies from behind. McDermott tries to tap it on. Ware grabs the ball and kicks it over his shoulder in the path of Cox. Cox marks.
Wow,
35 out, slight angle on this. Put this down on the book right now. This is a goal.
Oh, no, don't do that. Cox, that is curse.
No, your curse, not mine. This is a goal.
7 points of margin in favour of Hepburn. 3 minutes gone. Final term here at Mars Stadium. As Garvey comes off the ground for Hepburn.
Cox ambling in. Kick on the way.
Great kick.
Goal.
Great kick.
And it puts two goals in front now. 4 minutes, 3.5 minutes gone, last quarter. And it's Hepburn, 13-14-92 to 12-7-79. And it's all, and they've got a lot of room to make up now.
Yes, they do now. It's maybe just turning, Dave, slightly back towards Hepburn.
The Hepburn chant.
Listen, John, how good is the atmosphere here at Mars Stadium?
The Hepburn chant erupts around the stadium. Now it's tied up pretty quickly. McDermott's in the middle against Watt. McDermott won it just. O'Halloran dials in, grabs it, tackled as he kicked it, still got hold of the ball. And umpire said, no, mate, I'll have it. We'll have a ball up right in the middle of the ground again.
Everyone matched up all across the down. All placed right down the spine of Mars Stadium. Looks fantastic from up here. It's going to be really tight this last turn.
Another rack contest in the path of Orr. Orr gets a quick kick out of the pack, driving it forward. Trying to run onto it again was Orr. He chased up his own kick. Alan Ware doing battle. Orr pushes him out the road. Roving again was McKay. McKay onto Asaba Luisaya, who picks a massive tour.
Look at
his kick in 70 metres. And hits McKay on the head. And that doesn't matter. Bounces to his brother and handballs it out. But roving it is Duke tackle. McDermott has to get down. The big lumbering ruckman. He has a wide, wide target all by himself. And Mars Stadium out of side wing. Playing on. Long kick and a goal. Hitting on the chest.
Jinx.
It's Jenkins. Jinx and wheels around. He's got targets inside the goal square.
Oh,
Zane Thompson's there for half an hour.
Oh, where are we?
Jenkins.
I tell you what, you want to kick this goal now. You've got to kick the goal, Mitch.
Jenkins.
Out of side, Mars Stadium.
Oh.
Lake Windery
in. Deep in the forward pocket in front of the light tower. Come in. Stabs at it. It's bending back and it's a touched on the line.
Yeah. Brings the scores. Hepburn 13-14-92 to Beaufort 12-8-80.
Quick kick out. Taken it by Cannon Overly on a diving chest mark. Standing a mark is Rupert Sangster. Ogilvie's stab pass hits McDermott, the biggest bloke on the ground, on the chest for Beaufort.
How slow was that?
Oh, that's all.
50 on
the line. McDermott. McDermott looking for somewhere to kick.
McDermott in front of the big grandstand here at Mars Stadium.
Kicks it up and under the ball. Back forms. Oh, taking the mark almost was Zane Thompson. The ball hits the deck. Back forms. No, umpire. Forward 50. Right nearly on the arc of the forward 50 for Beaufort.
6 minutes gone. Final term. Beaufort 12-8-80. Hepburn 13-14-92. Tackles day 50-52 in favour of Hepburn.
There we go. Now clearance. McKay grabs it out, puts it long, big defensive punch by Beaufort, but they hit the dick. Burns grabbing it, outside wing, one bounce, has a look, takes the snow, kicks it, out of bounce on the full.
Got a kick, man.
Oh, he had Stanton in the middle by himself. He could have smacked him on the chest.
That's a big no-no for me.
Bit of me time there.
Must have been the man bun.
Oh, I'm not too sure. Might just tighten it a bit too much and cut a bit of circulation.
7 minutes gone. Final turn. Mars Stadium. Hepburn up by 12. 2 goals the margin.
Stanton was 3-2 in the middle of the ground. 15 metres out.
Both at Mars kick a goal.
Both? Oh, do you think? Only one.
Goal now. Just to get momentum back.
Next goal needs to go to Beaufort. Next goal has to be Beaufort. They just kick it long in the first 50. Pack forms. No one marks it. Umpires pull the mark out of this.
Robbie Simmons.
Robbie's pulled out a mark to Jackson Hogan. A little push and shove. Jimmy Rogers is in there again. The teenage prodigy. He's now turned himself into a game footballer as well. So Hogan, left footer. 10 metres out, pack forms, Cox air summer, raving Burns.
Burns
scores a try.
Push fair and squarely in the back, I would have thought.
Scores a try at the ball. Quick kick out. Picking a one-handed ball up was Orr.
Not kick out, mate. Soon come back.
Oh, yeah. What they got here? They're off here.
The ball bounced back in, so they tried to play on.
Oh, did they?
Yes.
The old sneaky little trick.
The old sneaky key stats. Tackles all tied up, 53 apiece. Inside 50s in favour of Beaufort, 46 to 43.
Beaufort have really tightened the screws here. Quarter's gone 8 minutes. It's
try to find someone to kick to. McDermott and his cohorts are making ways across to this broadcast
Alex
wing.
Alex Petrie, massive kick in.
They go that way. Falls over the back of the pack. Both have numbers. Handball, quick release. Reese misses the tackle. He's sprinting. Sprinting and sprinting more as Rupert Sangster has taken three bounces. Make that four. Closing on 50. Takes five.
Kick the goal.
Takes five. Handball to himself over the top. Falls over and knocks him up.
No.
He's absolutely cooked. He can't give chase. Grabbing it. Sprinting away from him.
Well done, son. Got to keep the game
on. As long as he can. McDermott wandering over it. Rupert Sangster.
Well done, Rupert Sangster. Tried to keep the game on. Had a fair crack, but just didn't pay off in the end.
Oh.
9 minutes gone, final turn. Both at 12-8, 80 Hepburn, 13-15-93 stadium.
Yeah, in football. Front of the interchange bench. Front position is Watts, handball to Ogilvie. Ogilvie to McKay. McKay, quick kick around the corner. Burns in front position. Trying to rove the ball is Clark. Clark fumbles it. In the part, Ogilvie gathers the ball. Goes one way, then the next. Wheels around on his left. Little stabby little pick to McKay. McKay takes the mark. Not much to kick to. Beaufort's got back numbers. Finds one in the middle. Beautiful kick to O'Halloran. O'Halloran just holds it.
Across to Leah Lusaya.
Lusaya drops a mark. Steps inside. Brushes the tackle. On to Burt. On the Brown. Brown inside one. Closing on goal. Kick it. Goal. Get it.
Get around him. Get around him.
Brown. Four goals.
Brownlee brings the score. Hepburn 14-15-99. To Beaufort, 12-8-80, 10 minutes gone, final quarter, Jacob Brown, 4 goals, fantastic effort, great play there. I'll tell you what, Dave, that might just about be curtains, 18 points of margin.
10 minutes gone, so I think about 15 minutes left, roughly.
Here comes the crowd.
We're at the Chandler Hepburn, and once again, the Beaufort supporters go awfully quiet. All right, here we go, hold the ball.
That's 50.
It's called 50. He's pulled out holding.
We're not playing anyhow, and you can't hear. Have a listen to the crowd. Just really soaking up here.
McDermott looking for that handball. We don't want to kick it. This sounds a bit of candy.
Petrie in the dish.
Dish. Kicks in the pass.
Great kick.
Stapleton, big cramp on the way through.
Every day of the week.
Looks like an Olympic diver.
Lachlan Murray was, sorry.
I apologise.
We'll kick from right on 50 here, Dave. 11 minutes gone, must kick the goal.
That was Alex Petrie trying to get the old Zach Tui kind of handball and kick the goal, got to set up.
He needs to remember where he is.
Old Greasy, he's sniffing around too. There we go, Lachlan Murray.
All poised.
Another goal, really needs to kick it. Heavily bent his left leg. Kicks it with said leg. Gets under the ball, the kick's the goal!
Great goal!
Exactly what they needed.
It's like playing tennis. They just return serve. Brings the score. Hepburn 14-15-99 to Beaufort 13-8-86. Wowee, Dave.
11.5 minutes gone. Last quarter.
13 points the margin. Oh,
I tipped this.
No, you didn't.
In the second half.
No, you didn't.
In the second half, I did. The second half.
Well, I'll tell you what. How's the news right now, both sides? Oh yeah, just get excited for the listener. Dave, back in the centre.
McDermott doing battle against Watt. McDermott wins it almost. Kick out of the ground by Watts, kicking in danger.
Free kick.
We're going to get the clearance here again, Beaufort. And taking the free kick is Sangster. Sangster hits it up.
Aussie. Oh, in danger.
In danger again. Oh, Burns misses the tackle, they should have stuck. Kicks out of the path. Crash bang wallop on the outer wing, on the centre wing. Roving again, his Sangster runs into a pack.
Petrie takes him on.
Like a bulldozer.
Back to Drewy.
Drewy. Oh, Mark, no, not taken. McCorkle's got hold of
Mark. He's stolen the ball off him.
And then play on. Out the outside wing, Morrow. Morrow flying shot of goal.
Garvey.
One out in the square. Hits it back. Both the guys stand there looking at it. Quick kick out to Murray. Murray brushes one.
Oh.
On the ball. Great tackle.
Oh, great. Well done.
Ripping tackle. And the Bay Lang, the tackle, was Jackson Livingside. Livingside, I should say. Now the ball's taken by.
In the team this week too.
Mitch McKay out the front of Burns. Burns goes to ground far too easily for my liking.
Lee Marshall picks it up.
Lee Marshall was, didn't want no part of picking it up.
Over.
Here we go. Beaufort's kick in front of the Reese, takes it, Reese, centre of the ground, takes off, hits 50, kicks long.
And Howard
takes it. Out, he's out by himself, he's Morrow in the long sleeves, needs a sit, turns inside out, which is Brad McKay. Another kick out, but his brother Andy bottles it up anyway.
Beaufort, clean that up.
Andy McKay just taking a bit of time with his block, all the experience.
Dan O'Halloran marching inside the centre square.
So Dan O'Halloran now, centre square. He now just drives inside 50, sees something is like an unguarded Jimmy Rogers.
Hasn't done anything all day, Jimmy Rogers, and pipes up in the final turn.
Jimmy Rogers.
14 minutes on the clock.
He's almost going to have to kick this from inside the paint, 45 degree angle.
13 points of margin, Hepburn's
over. Probably from 49 and a half metres. Maybe 49.6 metres, I'm unsure just yet. He's going to have a shot from goal.
A long time.
He's liking it. The umpire said down about moving it on. Thanks. He has a look around, Jimmy. Here he comes. Played his first grand final as an 18-year-old. Runs out. Gives a little bit of leverage. Kick on its way. Goal!
Ripping. 19 points the margin in favour of Hepburn. Brings the score 15-15-105. To Beaufort 13-8-86. Final turn, Mars Stadium.
Need the next two, bud. One goal, one cup. They need the next two.
55-56 tackles in favour of Hepburn. Inside 50s, 49-48 in favour of Beaufort.
Hepburn chance just going nuts. Clearance by Beaufort. The pass flying, roving the pack.
Right,
was beautiful. Was Mitch Jenkins taking a diving mark. And getting paid.
Wrongly bounced.
Mark was Liversidge, who hasn't been mentioned all game. He's taken two outstanding grabs. Kicks a floater. An absolute floater out to the outer wing.
Run
over by his teammate. McDermott handballs back. Handball out again. Little grubbing kick. Not much better than the one that went out. Buttering up again is Beaufort. Kick inside too. Oh, and bouncing off the chip. No, taking the mark is Tim Horsey. He'll go back, the goal kicker for the third quarter.
Dave, I tell you what.
Going back.
This really does set this game up before he kicks this goal.
I'm the glad
16 minutes gone, final turn, Mars Stadium.
I'm glad you're on the Horsey bandwagon now. That's all I
just
around.
Put up and shut up with you.
So Horsey, here he comes, skipping approach. Kick a goal, likes it, no. Misses near side. 18 points to lift, 3 goals with about 10 minutes to go, normal time.
Score is Beaufort 13-9-87 to Hepburn 15-15-105.
Little kick out. Damon Ogilvie deep in his defensive pocket. Just around for the fancy scoreboard. He then now just loads up, kicks it down the outer side wing to a pack. Everyone flies off, hands out of bounds. Boundary throw in 75 metres around for the Beaufort goal.
Centre clearances in favour of Hepburn 14-12. Free kicks in favour of Beaufort. 12-9.
Yeah, they've tightened the screws by Hepburn. They've done a cracking job. Now the ball gets thrown in. It's just a pack of players and it's gone absolutely nowhere.
I've just noticed this last term, Dave, Hepburn are just, they're hunting in packs, which is good to see. They're really, really hungry for this. They really want this win.
Well, the runners shouting instructions. And here we go. Another boundary throw up the centre clip. So ball up, I should say. 60 metres out from Beaufort's goal. Chasing the ball down was Ogilvie. Got dumped as he got rid of it. And then off feet. And off out of bounds on the fall.
Beaufort's kick.
Beaufort's kick. That's a bit stiff from the Hepburn point of view. So what can they do with it? This fourth entry, McDermott's just fighting around all by himself. They don't trust him. They just mumble inside. And the kick is straight down the neck of the Hepburn opponent, Santorini. Sant run last for a cheeky handball, making it also lead is Danskin. Goes to Sant, who now takes mark inside. Beaufort's goal square.
Daniel Rees lurking, wants another kick.
Plenty of holes there. Sant now just kicks another sideways ball to Anscombe. Anscombe deep inside his pop in front of the drink swilling members of the community on the hill in front of the old scoreboard. Anscombe kicks it long down the line. Should have taken the mark, but dropping it. The Stapleton now butters up. McDermott runs at the ball.
Big lumbering leg.
Just tries to smoke it. Shot at goal now.
Horsey.
No.
Across the face.
Murray in jibbing chase. Oh. Across the face, out of bounds. 10 metres around from the Beaufort goal.
18 and a half minutes gone, final turn. Beaufort 39, 87 to Beaufort. Hepburn 15, 105.
There you go, bounds you throw in. Garvey doing battle against Michael Watt. Michael Watt takes Garvey, tries to get around the back. McKay, a good kick out of the pack, giving chase and handballing it off to Alan Ware. Alan Ware, this fumbles it over the boundary line. It'll be a boundary throw in 60 metres around for the Beaufort goal. Outer side wing, Preswick Road side of the ground at Mars Stadium.
Centre clearance is in favour of Hepburn, 14-12. Free kicks in favour of Beaufort, 12-9.
Another quick kick out of the pack for Beaufort. Almost taken the mark with Ogilvie. A jug would have had a couple of nibbles at it, but ends up dropping the ball. The pack forms. The ball going nowhere. Now umpire will throw it up. 40 metres out from the Beaufort goal, and they really need to score now, Beaufort. The time is getting away from them.
Going around the grounds in the AFL, Sydney 26 to Essendon 9, 1 minute into the second term.
And for those people, clearance out the back, but Beaufort had three blokes run straight past the ball, which should have been a certain goal. Garvey gets the ball, handballs it over, thumped out of the defence by Beaufort, by Hepburn, I should say. Left footed kick by Stapleton. Stapleton, nowhere. Then he kicks to McKay. McKay kicks it out, smacks on the chest. Brown kicking it to McKay.
Clear,
kicking it long in the front of Cox.
Brandon Howard.
Cox just doesn't give chase. Just watch Howard amble away. Thumping ball out of the Reese's path was Lee Marshall.
Oh, you're joking. Call those free kicks late in the final term of the grand final, please.
So Daniel Reese, centre of the ground. Kicks up the end, part of Cox. Howard doing battle with Cox. Punches away by Howard. Stanton roves it. Quick snap. Jacob Brown in position, but thumped away. Garvey grabs the ball. Thought a handball. Thought himself into it. Now gets the handball out. Quick kick out.
Jenkins.
Ball bounces. Spins. Goes through three Hepburn opponents. The ball gets... Then the Beaufort bloke gets tackled as he handles it. Again, gets mowed over. Reese is in there. O'Halloran's in there. They're all going for it. The ball is tackled central now. Quick kick out by Duke. Duke, the path of his teammate McCorkle down under the same USA, handles it off to O'Halloran. O'Halloran out in the path of Joe Clark. Clark kicks it into the path of Brown. Brown goes to ground. His teammate, both of the opponent goes over top of him in McInnes. And the ball gets out of bounds.
Oh, we've got a poker player coming off the ground here in the last contest.
Not healthy. He's flipping a little bit.
Just trying to see who that is. We'll let you know shortly.
As
Lachlan Murray comes on the ground.
The boundary throw in right on the Hepburn's 50 metre arc. Andy McKay breaks two tackles, gets a handball out, dumped forward by Garvey. Now Beaufort have the ball. One bounce, two bounces, gets inside, handball out again. Link up play by Beaufort, exquisite in the middle area.
Need a move.
The kick wide, kick out in the path of Lee Marshall. Lee Marshall drops it. Lachlan Murray's free. Here's a Lachlan Murray, he drops the ball, he kicks a quick one. No in particular, but almost taking the mark down in the forward line. It was Petrie, I think it was. Alan Ware, ball bounces over his head. Taking the ball on now is Jack Duke, who gets tackled. Jack Duke handballs it back to Marshall. And now a little stabby kick hits Murray on the chest. Murray turns around, has nothing kicked to it except both of jumpers, so Hepburn jumpers. Murray loads it up, goes long in the path of McDermott.
Oh, taking the mark. Got to get contest drop. Wowee.
Going forward, you got to get contest.
18 points of margin, 22 minutes gone, final turn, Mars Stadium.
Watts takes the mark. Just goes long down the line. To the path. Garvey's there, runs past his teammate, pops it right in the bleak. Now handball on the ground. Murray again, another quick snap to a 3-on-1.
There's just nobody there, Beaufort.
And McDermott's just got no chance of taking the mark with Anscombe. He's milking the clock. He knows it's almost over. Defensive 50, looking for a switch. And just ambles away, kicks it long in the path of McKay. McKay trying to body his teammate, his opponent out, scoops it up, goes once, goes twice, Stanton there to help. Long, loopy handball to Ogilvie. Going long. McKay, no, bouncing ball, pulled out of bounds, beats him.
I tell you what, Dave, Lee Cox for Hepburn really done bugger all day, to be honest.
he's got the good goals.
Really can't chase. He might be a bit injured here. We're not quite sure, but just really struggling in this final turn.
Taking a couple of heavy knocks too. He got smoked a couple of times. The boundary throwing, 40 metres out from the Hepburn goal. Excellent clearance, going nowhere. The ball's just bouncing around like a ping pong machine. But McKay, I believe it is, gets the ball and kicks a little.
Daniel Reezy.
Reezy plays off. Takes one bounce, run down from behind, holding the ball. Great run down tackle by Rupert Sangster.
You love the name Rupert Sangster. Rupert Sangster in the defensive 50 for Beaufort. Looking for options, nothing down the line. Call play on now.
Oh, and the Garvey direction. Garvey gets his big mitt to it, the drops it.
Beaufort there.
And Alan Williams did know all about it as well.
Just quickly running through some stats. Tackles 61 to 64 in favour of Hepburn. Inside 50s. Beaufort up by one. The game really bouncing out with the inside 50s.
Yes, Banzi throwing. Tap in. Shanton there. Michael Watts is there. Holland's in out of the ball of pack, did like a bulldozer, just wrapped up. Scores from around the ground, 6 minutes mark of the second quarter in the AFL. Sydney Swans 6-2-38 to Essendon, 1-3.
Jason Oliver for Hepburn. Hepburn coach just made his way down the boundary line. Fist pump in the crowd, very happy with the result.
So I think it might be about
the Americans.
The Sayer, your Sayer, scores the ball. Handballing back, long, clear and
Jackson
kick.
Hogan.
In the path, O'Halloran flies at the ball, gets spoiled. Stanton grabs it, handballs out. Gooding got it at the Rogers. Rogers handballs O'Halloran. O'Halloran handball out to Clark. Clark, long driving ball. There's the siren. Hepburn, 2017 Central Highlands Grand Final. 13-9, 87 to 15-15, 105. Hepburn get the chocolates. Quarter went 25 minutes.
Wow, Dave, what a game. I tell you what, worth the 2-hour drive to see this fantastic performance today from both teams. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll play a couple of tunes. We'll be back shortly to wrap up what has been a fantastic game. We'll have our best players. We'll have the best on ground as awarded by the umpires. What a fantastic day it's been here. We'll wrap it up after these tunes.
Remind you that patrons are not permitted into the arena at this time. If we can have all the Gordon under 12s over to the presentation area, please. All the Gordon under 12s to the presentation area. Can we have all the Gordon under 12 players who are going to present the premiership medals over to the presentation area?